They don't lose regular season games to non-conference teams, and Texas is, of course, for one more season, 56 in a row. Going back to Shocker and Saban's first season. Sarkisian, the Broyles Award, as the top assistant under Saban in 2020, calling the plays. And there is Milroe. So much of the focus on the quarterback position in Alabama in recent years. They'd like to spread that focus around, right, to the running game and the defense, reemphasize those qualities.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, it's kind of a mixed bag right now. You know, they're trying to establish that identity with Tommy Rees. You know, there was talk in the offseason Nick Saban wanted to get more physical, be able to win games up front.
Of course, Texas would like to get back to the championship contention. It's been a little while, but most wins in FBS history, they rank 3 and 5, and Alabama is breathing in everybody's throat. And we talked about the physicality at the line of scrimmage. Alabama's always been known for that, but they think taken it to another level, or the level that they had when they were the dominant team.
Yeah, I think you go back to early Nick Saban, the Derrick Henry, big physical offensive line, win with defense, special teams, field position. Then he brought in Lane Kiffin, then he had Mike Locksley, then he had Sark, and it was a very different game. I think Tommy Rees, it's going to be a blend. I think he wants to be able to control the line of scrimmage, get into two tight ends, and dominate. But I also still think with Jalen Milroe, you're going to see a lot of spread because he's so good in space as a runner and a passer. So I think it'll be a blend. But we're actually going to be learning as we watch, including Nick Saban, watching his quarterback this year.
Learning about the new quarterback and the two new coordinators for Alabama. There always seems to be turnover there, but the beat goes on. Let's get down to Holly Rowe now, who's got Coach Saban.
Well, Coach Saban, you've talked to your team this week about playing with emotion, but also having composure. What will your quarterback, Jalen Milroe, need to do to have both?
He just got to take his emotions and focus on what he needs to do intentionally to do his job, do the little things better, simple things right. So I think it's more important that we're physical up front on both sides of the ball in this game so we can help him play well.
Your secondary had some guys banged up, but both warmed up and have moved well. What is your expectation for your safety and your star?
They're both going to start the game, so we'll see how they hold up.
Thank you, Coach.
That is the key. Those guys are going to be under pressure against the Texas playmakers, so they have full mobility. No surprise, Saban deferred after winning the toss, so Texas will get the football first, and we'll see Quinn Ewers come out of this cauldron of noise. Didn't make a big deal out of the fact that he was knocked out of the game on a roughing the passer penalty a year ago after lighting it up in the first quarter. Will Stone to kick it away. You say Will Riker. Keelan Robinson, of course, transferred from Alabama, back to receive. And he'll let it bounce. So here comes Quinn Ewers. Talked about the new look. He says it was a life-changing offseason. Really transformed himself. More command, more leadership, more camaraderie with his teammates. Some qualities that might have been slightly missing a little bit a year ago.
Well, I think taking over a lot of pressure in his first years, the weight of the world on him, and he got through it. But I think Sark naming him with Arch Manning coming in, the starter at spring, I think really helped his confidence and took him to another level over the summer.
Empty backfield, three receivers stacked off to the left, and they get to C.J. Baxter, the true freshman back who was knocked out last week with an injury, but back 100%, makes a big impact.
Yeah, if you're not familiar with Texas, and especially Sark, over his career as a play caller, what he does before the snap with formations and movement, and I talked to him on the field before the game, he said it's more important than the play call itself, especially tonight against Nick Saban's defense. Like, movements like that make this defense have to communicate and adjust.
We're taking to Baxter, pitch it to Xavier Worthy, and the speedster knocked down after a short game. Caleb Downs, safety, who is playing nicked up, makes the play.
moving quick, moving people pre-snap. Love to see Caleb Downs, by the way. If you're an Alabama fan, you know all about him. Highly touted, true freshman. You can see why the coaches rave about him, on how quickly he reacts to that play.
Hand the ball off and kind of bounce at his back. So these second downs are huge. They must, they feel, avoid those third longs against this pass rush.
Pretty good, you're right. Pretty good effort there by Baxter just to get some positive yards. This is about where they want to stay tonight. You know, he talked about being third and manageable. He said, if we get to third and seven plus against Nick Saban and Kevin Steele, they're going to dial it up and put us in a tough spot. We want to be in that third to 3 to 5 when we get in the third and medium.
Receiver stacked to the right now. They don't pressure yours. He's got some space. Can he get there with his legs? Yes. Scrambles and dives. That's the new athleticism. You lose about 20 pounds. He really hurt Rice in the opener with third down scrambles.
Yeah, and you know, you don't expect him to be that threat. Jalen Milroe, you do. But there, man coverage on third down. Nobody accounts for yours, and he does a good job seeing it, picks it up.
Jonathan Brooks, sophomore from Huntsville, his third year in the program, gets a few. You like the tempo?
Love the tempo. Not surprising at all. You got so many new faces in that Alabama secondary, especially with the safeties. You mentioned Caleb Downs. You have Jalen Key, the transfer from UAB. Malachi Moore, who's banged up but playing. He's kind of the quarterback in that back end.
Play action. Ewers has plenty of time, scans and checks it down to the tight end, Jatavion Sanders. The ball comes out. A scramble for it. And it looks like Texas may have retained possession. Knocking the ball loose was Malachi Moore. Not a turnover, but a huge game-wrecking loss.
I'm surprised that ball stayed in play. They called that a fumble. I thought it might have been an incompletion, how quickly that ball came out. Again, good job by Alabama taking away any options downfield. He just has to check this down. Bill, what do you think of that?
The play's under review right now. They're being buzzed for it. They got to look to see, did he have time to make a football move? Did he have firm control? My gut reaction is incomplete pass.
He's starting to tuck it away. The ball is kind of sliding against his jersey, and then the hit comes.
And what's a football move in that situation? Honestly, Bill, because that's such a gray area. What describe that pro.
It is. I mean, you can't put a clock on it. It's not about time. But does he own the ball, or was he borrowing it? And I don't think he owned the football on that one.
Okay. That's judgment, right? I mean, that's subjective to whoever's looking at it.
That's correct.
I like the expression. So right here, he's borrowing it. Hey, does he own it for a second? In super slow-mo, so it looks different.
Well, exactly. Exactly.
I always tell you guys, you can slow it down and make anything look like a catch.
Yeah.
Here's what it looks
here you go, Bill. Now we're going to give it to you a little bit faster.
Put a stopwatch on that. How long do you have?
It's a 14-yard difference. Texas still has the football, but get it back at the line of scrimmage, which is the Alabama 48 if it's ruled incomplete.
Again, how about Sark's approach to getting the ball first? Aggressive, up-tempo, attacking, a little bit of misdirection, trying to get an aggressive Alabama defense, maybe overflowing, going back the other way.
And then you were thinking, hey, don't forget about me as a scrambler. Didn't have to worry about that.
Right.
Last year. All opponents are going to have to take notice that Texas quarterback can hurt you. Not a lot of design runs, but that was great improv.
After review, it was an incomplete pass. It'll be third down and 8 at the 45.5 yard line. Third down.
You're looking at a third and 7 now compared to what would have been third and forever. So Sark now has a play, obviously, he feels good about here. On one of his first, remember, he said, we want to stay out of that third and 7+. Gives Nick Saban a chance to go to his money defense, where he gets 6 defensive backs out on the field. Gives him a much better chance of disguising pressures. It's a guessing game for that veteran offensive line and where they may come from if they do.
They must improve in the third down department this year. They're going to hand it off to Brooks. He plows across the right side and picks up a few, but is well short. Deontay Lawson made the tackle.
And, of course, that play call makes you think in plus territory. He's thinking about getting 3 or 4 yards to set up a chance, a better chance here now at fourth down and about 5. So he runs that play to set up this play right here. Trips to his left.
Still a bit of a gamble. You don't make it. Bama's going to be set up with great field position.
Also thinks it tells you about his mentality. He's here to win this game, willing to be aggressive.
Let's see if they actually do snap it. Play clock's at 5. And we'll see if it was just a bluff. Deafening in here. But aggression, when you show it with your calls, you back up what you've been telling your team all week long. He will punt the ball away, it appears. Helmet off.
And, you know, he maybe wanted to do that all along. I think if he picks up maybe another couple yards, maybe he does go for it. But now he's going to try to pin Milroe and this Bama offense in their first series down inside the 10-yard line.
Went to the portal to get a punter from Stanford. Ryan Sanborn's a grad transfer. Didn't get much work in the opener, only 2 punts against Rice. His job, pin him deep. Kool-Aid McKinstry, the fine corner, is also a dangerous returner. Sanborn drops the tip, and the coverage team does what they can. Some acrobatic moves to keep the ball out of the end zone. It's kind of a tag team effort. Keaton Crawford is the DB who first batted it back into play. And the first... AT&T 5G clicker, Kirk, revealing a mental error by Alabama.
Yeah, you see right here you have Keaton Crawford who's getting downfield. And what's interesting is Trey Amos at the top for Alabama saying, we need another defensive player out here. They only have 10 guys on the field. Crawford gets downfield because nobody's across from him. Bama with 10 guys. He ends up making that play to put him on their 1-yard line.
Ace McClellan, part of that running back rotation, the best all-around back in this team, and he just drives those legs and picks up 9.
Well, that's one way to overcome a mental mistake by Bama. You give it to the big guy. Remember, they got a big offensive line in front of Jalen Milroe. 3 guys over 350 pounds pushing people around and good, hard, tough running by McClellan there on that first play.
Ran for 2, threw for 3 in his debut. No Bama quarterback had ever done that in a game. He ended up the middle again, and McClellan moves the chains. 2 plays. They pick up about 14. Galen Catalan with the tackle. Talk about the beef up front. There are 3 guys over 350 pounds. Both Proctor and Latham. The tackles go 360. It's enormous.
Yeah, I mean, you really don't see that even in the NFL. These are big guys. True freshmen, by the way, the left tackle, Proctor.
Milroe. Clean pocket, flips it across the middle, off the hands of Amari Nyblack. The concern is in the middle. Seth McLaughlin is a mere 305 at center, going against big Trevondre Sweat and Byron Murphy.
Yeah, and I think that's the matchup we've all talked about all week, is Bama's size up front against Texas. You would think, okay, Texas trying to get ready for the SEC. Do they have the manpower up front? They do, with Sweat, Murphy, Collins, Broughton. They rotate a number of guys to stay fresh in the inside.
2-back look, Waddell Williams joining Bowen, and they flip it instead of the edge, and that's McClellan showing his versatility. Excellent pass receiver, and it's another first down.
Love to see this call. Love to see this call where you give him the option, and it shows you the athletic ability. Smart play by Tommy Reese to give him that shot, but he did miss Burton downfield. If he looked downfield, he saw a wide open Burton, got behind coverage and threw his hands in the air immediately. Out of frustration.
Burton over on the right now. Checked by Terrence Brooks. And first down, Milroe eludes pressure, shows the speed, has space, and is going to scoop for about 13. And a first down. He is so dangerous doing that.
Well, you bring pressure from the outside, you better keep contained. And there's the pressure to his right. Good job of breaking contain. And Texas has talked all week, we've got to keep him in the pocket. Make him play from the pocket. And right here, early in this game, you can see the athletic ability, what he can do if you lose contain there, even on the blitz that time from Barron.
Back-to-back 12-yard gains. Monroe slings that out of bounds. Jace McClellan, kind of a nice tackle on the blitzer that you mentioned off the edge. May have gotten away with something. Help his quarterback get free.
Could be.
You do what you can, right?
I'm really impressed. Talking to the coaches, watching Milroe in that first game against Middle Tennessee. Tommy Rees comes in for Billy O'Brien, who's now back in the NFL with the Patriots, getting ready to call plays tomorrow. And everybody wondered what kind of offense it would be, who's going to win the quarterback job. It was actually a question coming out of spring and going into camp. Milroe ends up winning it. Seems to have very good command of this offense.
Gets it out quickly, but makes a pick. It's intercepted. Jahdae Barron makes the kind of takeaway Texas needed and the kind of mistake that Saban was worried about with the inexperienced quarterback. Just didn't see it.
Yeah, and we talked about the command of the offense. It's one thing to have command of the offense. It's another thing to be able to read and recognize coverage. Great job of kind of baiting this throw. I think he's anticipating the coverage there with Barron was going to sink. See how he initially sinks, and then he comes off of it and steps right in front of Burton for that interception. So good job of disguising, good job of affecting the eyes of Milroe from pre-snap to post-snap by Texas secondary.
Barron, an unsung guy, the glue to the secondary, makes the first big play of this game and sets up Ewers in the offense at the 30. Baxter makes a cut. Cannot believe he's a true freshman. You see him on the field, powerfully built lower body.
Yeah, I mean, 6'1", 218 out of Orlando, went to Edgewater High School, had a rib that hurt him last week, kind of came down on the ball. It's good to see him back. But they, you know, you lose an outstanding back, the top back in the country, and Bijan Robinson now with the Falcons, and you load back up with four guys that are outstanding. So they'll rotate a committee tonight.
Keelan Robinson and Jonathan Brooks flanking the quarterback. That's Worthy in motion. And they're running to the right again. Trying to physically challenge this Alabama front. It's right near the marker. Desmond Marshall, the transfer from Georgia, made the stop.
Fired up is Keelan Robinson to get his chances to touch the ball. Played at Alabama, of course. Transfers over to Texas. Very familiar with that entire roster. He's a little guy, but that time he lowered his shoulders. 5'9", about 190 pounds. Picks up that first down.
Texas in the red zone. Another area they need to improve from a year ago. On the trick play, Adonai Mitchell makes a cut and bangs downfield. Loses the ball. It came out at the end. And Jatavion Sanders, the tight end, falls on it to prevent a turnover.
I think Caleb Downs, the true freshman, knocked that ball out. He'll come in late. Malachi Moore right there. Actually, Moore ends up getting it. Downs hits him. But I think it was Malachi Moore's left hand that got on that football. Very fortunate for Texas. The big tight end, Sanders, there, aware, and jumps on top of it. Nice play there by the veteran, 13.
Better hold on to the ball tightly against this defense.
They attack. They attack the ball, yep.
Second and five. Baxter off the pump fake, has it on the edge. A big collision. There's going to be plenty of hitting tonight. Deontay Lawson, excellent linebacker, knocked him out about a yard and a half short of the marker.
Yeah, this is my kind of game. I love to watch backs that are going to lower their shoulder, linebackers and safeties that are coming up. Major collisions tonight.
One of those high impact early plays. Texas settled for three too often. That's what cost them last year. Ewers scanning, batted up in the air, and a diving attempt incomplete. Worthy couldn't come back to it. Big Jaheim Oates got a hand on it, and a decision for Sarkisian. The offense is out there for now.
They get a good push from the left side, and nice job of timing this up right there just to get his hand on it. Oates knocks that down. Sark's got another decision here on fourth down. And Xavier Worthy is his go-to guy. He's matched up one-on-one with Kool-Aid at the top up here.
Ewers on the move. Flips it short. Catch made. First down converted. That Sanders knocked out at the five. The gamble pays off.
Yeah, recognize he's going to get man-to-man coverage. Uses Jordan Whittington, 13. Almost sets a screen. He was the inside receiver. Works to the outside. And a good job because of that man beater. He's able to use him almost like a pick to get underneath him. Affected the defender. Made it an easy read and throw that time for Ewers. So remember that conversion there on fourth down.
Job still far from done. First and goal from the five. Play action, Ewers, slant, and incomplete. Malachi Moore arrived to knock the ball loose. Jordan Whittington, the intended receiver.
Yeah, he's looking right here on an RPO to find out if the freshman's going to come down. You see him come down. Once he comes down, that tells him, okay, let's pull it. Hit that slant right behind it. Ball just a little bit high to Whittington. Probably could have gone up, climbed the ladder, and come down with that ball. But good recognition there on the RPO by Ewers.
It's tough to beat Malachi Moore in a matchup down by the goal line. Two-back look, Robinson and Brooks. Hand off. And nowhere to run. Robinson stacked up right at the line. It's going to be third and goal.
Wait, Chris Braswell, we always think about Alabama edge guys, and we think about what kind of pass rushers they are. This is what impresses me. 260 pounds. Watch him set the edge there. Gets his hands on that big offensive tackle, Christian Jones, and kind of holds the edge and pushes him back, forces that back into the inside where that defense is flowing.
There's a pause because big Tim Smith, one of the defensive ends for the Crimson Tide, being looked at by the athletic trainers.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by IHG Hotels and Resorts. 18 hotel brands, one loyalty program. Download the app. And in part by Allstate, proud sponsor of the Allstate Crossbar Classic.
Nick Saban's second national title is first at Alabama. Marcel Darius, Texas fans don't want to see him. Fellow who knocked out Colt McCoy early. I think he had a big man touchdown in that game, too.
Sure did.
Mark Ingram and company in the Rose Bowl. To Texas, Kirk, third and goal from the four. Is he still thinking, I got two plays to get to the end zone?
I don't know why it would change. You know, other than, you know, they have not. You and I were talking to Drake. You get a first down, it's not like you're done here. You got to punch this thing in. And it's what Alabama's defense takes pride in, is these goal line stands.
Ewers, long throw to the end zone, off the hands of Xavier Worthy, who had a touchdown. It was a beautiful throw. And now it's fourth down. Here comes the field goal team.
Just a great route. He's in motion before the snap. I think McKinstry thought he was going inside. He immediately puts his brakes on and goes back to the outside. You'll see him motioning. Now he comes back, caught him, really out-leveraged him, and had that chance.
Worthy, their best playmaker. That was potentially a four-point play. Here comes Bert Auburn, who is a solid kicker, kicked what could have been the game winner if Bryce Young hadn't driven Alabama down the field for the walk-off field goal. Bert Orange draws first blood, but they settle for three and close.
Texas A&M, they're getting routed in Miami.
That's a sweet one for Cristobal. Needed a big win. Came to be ranked now, I think.
Yeah, that was a huge game of all the games this weekend outside of this one. Both teams were 5-7 a year ago. Somebody needed that to kind of create some momentum in the other team, in this case A&M, back to the drawing board.
There it gets by Kendrick Law, so the Crimson Tide will take over. Ridiculous how many skilled position players Bama has sent to the NFL in recent drafts, but Kirk, what's noteworthy is the quarterback position. That's what's been different lately. The last four all starting in the NFL. People criticized the Eagles when they took Hurts in the second round. Two, of course, Mac Jones and Bryce Young, the number one overall pick.
Yeah, and now it's Jalen Milroe. Like you said in the open, I mean, that position has changed drastically, just like the offensive style changed when Lane Kiffin came in, Mike Locksley, Sark. That position became a position where they went all over the country to find the top quarterbacks, and it's paid off for them, and we'll see how number four can do.
Milroe, Texan. Katie, Texas is near Houston, so extra motivation tonight. Got to bounce back from that first pick, though. He's got a keeper on the edge, makes a nice cut. Ooh, is very close to break even. Shoestring tackle there made by Ethan Buck, or Burke, I should say.
Yeah, this is a great read. Here's read 91. 91 collapses. Very easy for him to pull that, but it was that second level quick move. Shows you the instincts that he has right there, being able to avoid Catalan coming up quickly from that safety spot.
Hand it off McClellan. So McClellan bangs forward, still running. He's running hard tonight into Texas territory at the 49.
Well, we wondered who would win this battle. Look at this double team right here. Watched him work and try to move out Big Sweat. 360 pounds. Good job of holding him there. And then some tough running to be able to run through those arm tackles.
And David Bendu just bounced off McClellan. Got it again, picks his way with patience, and it's going to be wrestled down. Tackle made from behind there by Jalen Ford. So they probably had a conversation, Reese and Moses, calm down, shake it up, and then go to the running game right away, by the way.
Yeah, exactly. And I, what do you say about Chase McClellan? Because the running back spot, sometimes you see a guy come in right away like a Mark Ingram who plays early. Other times you see a B-Rob. Brian Robinson had to kind of sit around, wait his turn to become the guy. Josh Jacobs had to kind of wait around a little bit. And I think McClellan and also Roydell Williams have been that kind of guy.
Williams has the ball now. He slides forward for about seven. They like the running back room. You're right. None of them are super heralded coming in. McClellan ran for 651 a year ago.
Yeah, but I think you really appreciate how they persevere through sitting back. A lot of times in this transfer portal era, the guys leave. These guys waited their turn to become the guy, and they've got some very talented young guys, Justice Haynes and also Jam Miller, that'll get some looks tonight, too. Deep room.
Third and four. And they hand off, trying to run for it. That time, Texas front swarms on Williams, and that was Saban with a chance to make a decision. They need three on fourth down.
Yeah, it's five plays after that interception and five run plays by Nick Saban and Tommy Reese. And productive. Now we'll see what happens here on fourth and three. It looks like they're going to go empty.
The early chance for Texas defense to keep building the Longhorns' momentum if they can get off the field here. They come after Milroe. Gets it out. And the catch is made. Going up and grabbing it is Malik Benson using those long arms. And it's a first down.
Well, you had a mesh concept right here. But I'll tell you what. I don't know who he's throwing to. I will say it's the junior college transfer Benson who climbs the ladder. But he also had Burton in there too.
Moving quick. And flipping it short to Amari Nyblack. And the tight end is going to be knocked down after about a 4-yard gain. Give him the benefit of the doubt on that one.
Yeah, I will. It's first throw of this series to be able to pick up that conversion. And then they go back to working the edges. Run up the middle, work the edge. Texas trying to rotate some fresh bodies on this field.
And Bama running some tempo here. McClellan has a crease. And he's going to be knocked down, but not before they move the chains again inside the 25. Catalan stopped him.
McLaughlin to center. Love how he turns his body to the left. Watch him turn that Texas defender, Murphy, and opens up a nice hole. Also the right guard, Darian Dalcourt. Very nice job by this offensive line. They knew the challenge. They heard about it all week. Texas is big. They're deep. They're strong. Are we going to be okay up front? They've taken that challenge personally.
Going again. And this time runs into a swarm of Longhorns. Have got him right at the line of scrimmage. Final minute of a quickly paced first quarter.
Better job up front, forced him outside. The whole goal of this defense, much like Alabama's, is those big guys want to eat up offensive linemen and free up Jalen Ford and Jet Bush and the rest of these backers, Benda, to be able to get downhill and make plays. But when things are controlled up front, it's tough for those backers to get down where they can affect the run game.
Milroe launching to the end zone, broken up beautifully. Ryan Watts, excellent cover corner, Ohio State transfer, denying Brooks a touchdown.
And watch the eyes the entire way. Doesn't bite on that at all. Perfect technique there by Watts. In position, a veteran guy started all last year with that length. Keep in mind, he's 6'3 as a corner. With that length, he almost came up with an interception, but really impressed by the eyes looking back at the quarterback.
Watt's motivation, he let Bryce Young get away on the scramble last year that set up the game-winning field goal. I'd love to atone tonight. Nice play there. Milroe backpedaling and flips it at the last minute. Incomplete. Roy Dale Williams had worked free down the sidelines, and that will be the final play of the first quarter, and it's 4th and 10, so the Crimson Tide figure to send out the field. 33. This is from 42 to tie the score. Yeah, gets it up very quickly and hits it at the top of the net from 43. Two really good kickers could play a huge role in this one tonight. Tying Kirk drove it 51 yards in a methodical 12 plays and settled for three.
Oh, good job by Texas defense. They were giving up some yards there, but they were able to get them off the field and force that field goal.
What a scene. Good, you're providing the aerial coverage, celebrating the challenge of road games everywhere. Are you ready for the road? Goodyear, more driven.
With that
guys,
drive,
with right that, down the street with game day this morning.
Yeah, that was great.
Good
yeah,
scene here.
What a scene. Denny Hall's great backdrop. Love this this scene anytime you come in here for a big game. With it. Where that drive started, I think these Alabama fans were loving seeing, again, going back to that, what style of offense will Bama run this year? They've been such a spread team with the quarterbacks we just showed on that graphic. And with Milroe, it's going to be a different game. Some zone reads, some QB run stuff. Still can spread you out, but as you saw on that drive, they can now really pound that line of scrimmage and rely on a stable of backs to get behind that big line.
Yeah, a lot of plays for script defense. Throw the ball. We want to see excitement. Big plays. What excites him here? Smash mouth, right? Just right away. Pounded on the ground. That's the DNA of Alabama. Here comes Quinn Ewers, who's had a lot of different looks. There's been a lot of focus on the hair. And also, let's focus on the scale. Because he was 205. Texas dropped down to, well, actually up to 207, up to 218. Yeah. Kept gaining weight. And then this year, a real commitment through his diet to drop down to 195. Feels more athletic, feels more comfortable running the ball.
Yeah, and I just think talking to him this week, he's just kind of got his life in order off the field, you know, his priorities. His faith means a lot to him, and I think it just kind of got his life in order in every other aspect. You know, it's a guy you pull for. Been through a lot in Austin just a couple years.
Downfield shot, launch for Worthy, and it's incomplete. Tracking over was Caleb Downs, the safety.
Well, they have been running the football. They've been throwing a lot of quick throws. Stein, they rely on that offensive line to be able to hold up there. Gave him a great pocket, and they're trying to hope that the safety, the freshman Downs, might be getting his nose up there, thinking about a quick pass or a run. But he showed some good discipline getting back there to be in position. If that ball was accurately thrown, he could have been able to come up with that pick.
Such an off-season emphasis. It was not as strength of Ewers a year ago throwing the deep ball. 0 for 7 from beyond 20 yards against Rice. And it's tough to move the ball against defenses like this if you can't make them respect the downfield threat, stretch the field. Short gain, and now a third and long.
And again, Alabama's style forever, since Nick Saban's been the head coach, is keeping two safeties back. And they rely on their 3-4, three down linemen and four linebackers to stop the run. If you can't make one of those safeties have to come down because you're running the ball on them, and they can stop the run with two safeties back, you're going to have a long night.
Third and 7, typically no fun for opposing offenses. A rush for Ewers, has time, flips it, completes it, and a first down. Jordan Whittington made the catch, absorbed a hit, and moves the sticks.
Really good route, but nice job with the pocket presence. Here's your route right here, but watch how Ewers kind of navigates the pocket. Doesn't panic, works it, keeps his eyes downfield. Outstanding route there on third down, but let's give that offensive line, that veteran group, tip of the cap for holding up on third down.
And Worthy, it's a backwards pass. He can throw it. Launching downfield. Contested ball. Is there a flag? Yes. Terrion Arnold was defending. Anthony Mitchell just grabbed the jersey.
Yeah, he grabbed it on that shoulder pad, on the top of the shoulder pad, grabbed the hold of that jersey. We all know that Mitchell, with his experience at Georgia, he can get downfield in a hurry at 6'4".
Pass interference. Defense number 3 with a 15-yard penalty. It is first down.
Such a focus on penalties for Alabama a year ago. 15 in the escape at Austin, most in the Saban era.
Yeah, lateral, so he can throw this ball. And if you look close, you'll see, without a doubt, Arnold started to feel threatened. He does a good job right there. He grabs onto that jersey, and he does it again. And again, he held onto that for about 10 or 15 yards.
I said that because that's probably when you're coached to do, right? It's going to be a touchdown, he believes, if he didn't grab the jersey.
Now, he might have had his eyes starting to peek at Worthy, thinking about that quick throw to him. Got out of position just by about a half step.
So Texas back in Bama territory. Ewers from the pocket. Now he'll loft one downfield. A ton of air running underneath it. Worthy's got it for a touchdown. The deep shot this offense has been seeking desperately. They strike from 44.
What a throw by Ewers. And a great read. He's looking right here to read the safety, Key. And if he bites up on this underneath route, he's going to take a shot. You can see how he feels. Okay, I got him where I want him. Let's put it up in the air, one-on-one against the freshman. And he goes to one of the top receivers in the country, Worthy, for a huge play for the Horns here early.
You can see what it means. Not just a touchdown, but a deep shot. Yes, Sarkisian, what would it mean for Ewers to connect on one of the first couple deep shots you throw? Because they tested Alabama a lot a year ago, just not very successfully. He just smiles. It'd be a good thing. My quarterbacks hit one of those early.
Well, Sark kind of baiting Alabama in the first quarter. Quick, a lot of up-tempo, quick throws, run game, ball out of the hands quick. But three times on this possession, they took those shots downfield, and they finally hit one.
Bert Auburn still perfect in PATs for his career. So Quinn Ewers wafting a deep, Worthy runs underneath.
I'm not salty. Triscuit, unapologetically wholesome.
You're watching the Allstate Crossbar Classic.
Don't forget that Texas 3rd-and-7 conversion to Whittington early in the drive, then the double pass. Draws the pass interference. The 44-yard strike to Xavier Worthy. Stone to boot it away. And pretty throw.
This is beautiful. And again, good protection. But watch how high. This is a moonshot. Hopefully Russell Wilson somewhere is watching this, because that's how he throws it. Way up in the air to give your receiver a chance to adjust as a progressive pylon cam to show you that beautiful catch. And how about Worthy? Drops the ball earlier for a touchdown, and a great player bounces back and makes a great play here for Texas's offense. Okay, Ewers looks different than he did last year.
Literally, but also not just literally.
Just the poise in the pocket, that third down throw, moving around, navigating his way, not panicking.
They won't panic at Alabama, but this is a challenge for Milroe. They go back to the ground here. Raydell Williams hammers straight ahead. Texas has got to be honed in on that right now.
Now, Bryce Young's not here, right? So this is where we're right in front of our eyes. We are going to learn about the Alabama team in 2023. Down 10-3. How do you respond to adversity? Bryce Young saved this team last year in this game, especially in the fourth quarter, and he did it so many times. Anxious to see how this team, not Bryce Young, the team responds.
Monroe flips it to McClellan, who motion out wide, and he just dropped the ball. Had a lot of space. Looked his eyes on Jay Barron.
Yeah, he looked up at Barron. He started to think about what he was going to do before he was able to watch his head. I mean, he literally just right there starts to peek, thinking about, let me make a move here to get around him.
Tied yet to convert. 0-for-2 on third. Need 5 here. Scrambling, thinking about running, now flips it over the middle, and it's caught at the 40 in heavy traffic. Jermaine Burton came down with a tough catch to keep the drive going.
Yeah, they sneak out of the backfield, but Texas is playing zone. Williams is covered by the corner, so Milroe has to come off of him, and this is where he can create, and he makes a heck of a throw.
Playing quick after the first down, and plowing ahead is Williams, stopped by big Byron Murphy.
You know, a lot of times you'll see Milroe scramble to run. That time on third down, a great job of scrambling, eyes downfield, and then finds Burton for that first down. Asking the Alabama players, we were talking to Kool-Aid yesterday, how fast is he? I mean, is he top 10 on the team fast? No. Top three fast on this team. He can go.
They bring pressure. He's flushed. Milroe on the edge. Pump fake. Still alive and now just steps out of bounds after a short gain. Pursued there by Barron.
And it gives you an idea of what he can do off of that play action look. I mean, there's good pressure that time by Sorrell, but he gets around him and then has another defender and Barron to deal with.
Looking for Dan Kirk.
Yep.
Interesting to see how Kwiatkowski approaches this. Have to be aware of the scramble. How aggressive can they get? Walking the man up. And they do bring some pressure. And they'll get him back at the 32. David Benda, who's had a little bit of a rough start to this game, makes a big play, and Texas gets a stop.
Well, Milroe is used to being able to buy time with his legs. This time, look at both the linebackers. Benda ends up coming. Look how he goes down. Pretty good block and a good pickup by McClellan. But the effort, watch 33, he's down on the ground, gets up, decides to finish the play with that motor, and comes up with a big sack.
Wow. How often do you see a dude knock to the ground, get up, and make a sack? Worthy just got the touchdown, drifts back to receive the punt, but it's going to bounce near the sideline and now back in the field and works out very well for the Tide. So James Burnett does his job and Texas will be backed up a touchdown here.
Welcome to Sabrina's Laws of the Game. Pay attention, you might learn something. Law one, be a student of the game.
And that school just dominates.
Law two, practice. Law three, see everything.
She has eyes in the back of her head.
Law four, use doubt to your advantage.
When I was a kid, I used to play grown men for Slurpee money. Now, I got my face on a Slurpee cup.
Name of UCC Commissioner Greg Sankey here. There's David Cutcliffe. He's a special assistant coach. Good to see him. And buddy Matthew McConaughey, the Minister of Culture of Texas. Bama's got a bunch of ex-stars here. A.J. McCarr, Jameer Gibbs.
Big night the other night. Upset the Chiefs. What a great career he had, not only in Alabama, but in the NFL. Dante Hightower.
He's got that feeling. Everybody wants to be here tonight. Glad you're with us. Texas from the 7, up 7. The delay, Baxter just wrestled to the ground.
Got a flag there. Down.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 92. 15-yard penalty.
Boykby reached up with a big arm and dragged the freshman down.
Yeah, he sure did. Just trying to chase the ball, but that left hand gets up high and brings his Chris, that freshman down. And Texas, after horrific field position, Bama got exactly what they needed with that great punt. But now that 15-yard penalty gets him outside of the 20.
Bama fans thinking, oh no, not penalties again. Very nearly cost him that win a year ago. Jaden Blue is in the backfield. He's got the ball on the edge, gets a block, and is knocked down out near the 30 after 8 by Marshall.
So you see Baxter, the freshman. Brooks is going to have a chance to come in there. We've already seen Kalen Robinson. Now you get a look at Jaden Blue, like we said, with Bijan Robinson out. Bijan Robinson off to the NFL. Now have four backs trying to replace he and Roshan Johnson.
Blue again, swarmed. No game. Third down is a big story so far. Texas will need four this time. Sanders, Worthy, stacked to the right. Ewers looking that direction. Hit as he throws, but it's complete across the middle. And it is big Jatavion Sanders making an impact here in the first half. First down to the 45.
Bama, a mistake here. You bring pressure, but because of this formation, I don't know if there's a... Look at the middle. Look at Xavier Worthy's wide open. You got two Texas receivers wide open and a bust in coverage there in the middle.
Playing quickly. Worthy on the edge. Has a couple blocks. Stutter step. Burst through a crease. They are moving the sticks in a hurry inside the 40.
Good blocks downfield by the receivers. Whittington and Mitchell. Ball gets out quick. Helmet on a helmet. Good speed there in space.
Worthy again. Got a play caller and a quarterback in rhythm right now.
Yeah, and Sark, he and Lane Kiffin, from the time they left USC, they'll go right, like you see in the NFL. If they like a play, they'll go right back that very next play. It's not like, we'll come back two or three series later. They hit it that next play until you're going to make adjustments. It's like Braswell coming off the field. Wonder if fatigue starts to set in for Alabama.
That's the idea behind what Sark is trying to do. And they fake it. Worthy on the end around. Cuts underneath. Buddy might take it wide. Terry and Arnold brought him down to prevent a big gain. It'll be third down.
Wow. Watch this. Watch Sanders Zero go back. Now he's going to go the other way. Look at these offensive linemen. They got nobody to block downfield. Nobody there. What a play there by Arnold.
Saved a huge play, maybe a touchdown.
Yeah, he had a convoy.
And Worthy's in the backfield to the right of Ewers on this third and four. Different look. They fling it to him. Creative ways to get number one the ball, who bounces off two men, gets a first down to the 22. Shows the toughness as well as the speed.
It shows the toughness, but really, really bad technique here by Arnold coming up at corner and Key. They just try to use their shoulder pads, just try to hit him. Nick Saban wants to see you wrap up there. Kevin Steele wants to see you wrap up.
Playing fast again. Brooks, a swing pass. It feels like easy money on the edge now. They get five more.
They're going back to where they were earlier in this game. Up tempo, ball out of the hands quickly. You talked about the rhythm with Sark and Ewers. Ewers playing with tremendous poise. Even though they're going a lot faster, his feet are under control, his eyes are under control, and he's in rhythm.
10th play of this high-tempo drive. Baxter tries to bounce it. Patience and enough strength to get a few. It'll be third and short this time.
This Texas offensive line with this tempo, they're the beneficiaries at the line of scrimmage. They're going to go quick here. See if Bama gets lined up.
Couldn't get fresh bodies in there, could they? Because of that tempo, Baxter just powers and muscles for another first down to the 13.
Bama not even getting to it. You can see they're frustrated. They want to get the call in. There's some miscommunication right now with Alabama just trying to get the call in. You can see that defense frustrated. They didn't get lined up. Look at the defensive line. You got open gaps there. Good job by the freshman bouncing around and a good push up front.
They're still looking around making signals to each other. Cleats in the grass, what they like to say. They're not really ready. Yeah. On the edge, catch made by Whittington, and he's going to be tackled. Now back in the red zone, Kirk, and another one of those critical series here as Texas would love to stretch this to a two-touchdown lead with halftime approaching if they can.
Now, 12th play of this drive for Sark. A lot of it has been tempo. Bama now trying to adjust, trying to get some fresh bodies on the field. That was a tired defense. Even Texas, look at their offensive lineman. It's a test of willpowers here.
Temps in the low 80s tonight. Be a factor as we grind on here. A lot of traffic in the backfield. Ewers flips it, and it's broken up beautifully. Kool-Aid McKinstry came flying across to prevent what looked like a touchdown.
Boy, outstanding poise here by McKinstry because he sat back, read the quarterback's eyes. They tried to troll the entire Alabama defense to the offense's right. He stayed home, recognized the back Brooks slipping out, almost a touchdown, but good discipline there by Kool-Aid McKinstry.
Certainly catchable, but McKinstry's speed made it a trickier proposition. Third and 10. Pressure. Mueller's escapes, makes a move, and will stumble forward. He'll be stopped at the 10. Deontay Lawson knocked him down. The tie didn't get a stop, and here comes the field goal team.
Yeah, they're going to bring pressure right here. Kind of rolling the dice, getting aggressive, trying to be able to affect the timing. Ewers thinking, we saw him scramble for a first down earlier on a big third down play. This time takes off, but they're able to rally to the football with eyes on a quarterback.
So Auburn kicking against Alabama, which somehow feels appropriate. Good from 22 earlier, this from 29. And he is still perfect in the night. So Texas, a grinding 14 play, 82 yard drive, almost 6.5 minutes, leaded by 10.
Ray Magliozzi here. When you need parts, eBay Motors ensures a guaranteed fit. Hey, Dave.
Yep. Wait.
How are those new wipers?
They're small.
Just go to eBay Motors, where the check means a guaranteed fit. Let's ride.
This season, we have more pressure than I ever would have imagined.
If we do not get promoted, we are in trouble.
This year is the year.
Yeah, you can just feel now there's stakes
here.
We're all in physically, all in financially, and all in emotionally.
Burden isn't just that promotion. It's not ever letting down this community.
FX's Welcome to Wrexham premieres Tuesday at 10 on FX. Stream on Hulu.
Shelves. Shelves smart enough to see. Sense. React. Restock. So Caramel Swirl is always there for the taking.
So yeah, USAA, they always have my back.
USAA? You were in the military?
Oh no, I wasn't, but my grandpa was. He joined USAA, passed membership to my mom, then to me.
There's other ways to get in?
Yeah. My neighbor Ron, he's in because his wife served. Even little Luna, once she's born, her dad served.
So all this time, I could have had USAA insurance.
And banking.
Where's my phone?
Over there.
USAA, for the military community and their families.
Did we just get hustled? There's no way they were 70.
Interesting. It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
So JJ's for lunch?
Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both. The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Almonds, every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
With college football on ESPN Plus, you get the best teams and the biggest conferences, and so much college football action from across the country. So sign up now at ESPNPlus.com.
UFC 293. Buy it on ESPNPlus.com/PPV.
Light show, music pound, trying to get the folks going here. Goodyear providing the aerial coverage. Road tested and game ready. Are you ready for the road, Goodyear? More driven. You know you're ready for this. Opener of Monday Night Football. Have you heard about the new quarterback for the Jets? Aaron Rodgers against the Bills. Joe Troy and the gang at 8 Eastern.
You heard of Josh Allen?
I have heard of him.
It's going to be a great game. That is a great way to kick it off.
New look countdown. Is it 6 Eastern? Well, here's the report card for Jalen Milroe. Take a break and he'll go back to work. 33 yards passing so far and an interception.
I'm Elizabeth, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Honey Pepper Pimento Chicken Sandwich is the collab of flavors. The sweet honey, the pickled jalapeno peppers, and the creamy pimento cheese.
It is a perfect bite.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the richness of the pimento cheese. When I took a first bite, I was like, go.
Trade for $5 bites at Dave & Buster's. You know you want to.
I'm Matt Barry, coming up in the Mercedes-Benz Halftime Report. What a day of college football we have. Colorado, a Shador thing at home. We'll have highlights of that. Plus, Aggies agony in South Beach. And Notre Dame, plenty of Hartman again today. Dan Mullen, Joey Galloway, join me coming up on the Mercedes-Benz Halftime Report.
Matt, thank you. I watched it, but I'll stick around for the Buffalo's highlights again at halftime.
They look great.
Those again.
Yeah, they look great.
Okay, 4:05 before halftime. Can Milroe get something going with the pass game? Instead, he takes off quickly. This is what he does best. Makes a cut and quickly sprints for 20 yards.
That's a design draw here for the quarterback. He loves to run. Tommy Reese told us yesterday, this is what he loves. Spread out a defense, get these linebackers in space, see the center, see the back leading him. That's a quarterback draw by design. Great call there by Tommy Reese. That thing opened up. Puts a lot of pressure, not only with those the center out in front there, McLaughlin, but what speed by this quarterback, Milroe.
So more yards rushing than passing for Jalen so far. Hands it off. McClellan simply cannot get the edge. Good pursuit out there. It was a nice play by Catalan.
Yeah, boy, Catalan, the transfer from Arkansas, built a reputation as one of the more physical linebacker safeties in college football when he was at Arkansas and had the ACL last year. He sits out. Texas fans are going to fall in love with his energy and his aggressive nature. You saw that right there and how quickly he came up.
Plays with a lot of passion. A little bit reckless at times, but in a good way. Pressure. Milroe backpedals and just has to throw it away. Aaron Sorrell came after him. He's been a force.
Good job of bringing pressure from the left and winning battles one-on-one. You see right here, eventually that's going to force him out. But watch these big defensive linemen win some one-on-one opportunities. Sorrell just beats his man, the freshman, Caden Proctor, on that left side.
Some big, fresh bodies to the Longhorns trot out there for this third and 11. They've got tremendous depth up front. What a luxury to have in college football these days. Walk up some pressure, show it, and then bail. Milroe sets up, scanning, thinks about taking off, and will be knocked down well short of the marker. Good coverage, didn't see anything he liked. Anthony Hill Jr., the linebacker, was there to help clean it up.
Yeah, they're just going to spy with him here. That's the freshman. I thought he might get lost here. You can see him. He's staring. He knows about the speed. Overcommits. I thought he might be in trouble, but his speed, and he gets help there from another defensive back, Ryan Watts. And they get Bama, who's trying to put any kind of points up on the board here before the half to get him off the field.
Is that speed making up for less than perfect instincts in that play?
Yeah, he overcommitted. I thought he lost contain, and I thought it was an opportunity for Milroe, but Milroe wanted to throw that football, kind of stayed behind the line.
Spy, a very important job for any opponent of Alabama this year, the way Milroe can run. But in the end, it ends up in a punt, and they pin Texas back deep yet again. They've done that piece pretty well. 1:58 before halftime. Quick word now from Verbo.
A place to reunite with your actual family of five and your chosen family of 105,213. Verbo. Football away, baby.
Kirk, what do they do here? It's been a great rhythm for yours. They've got some time. They got three timeouts, but they're also pinned back.
Yeah, I think it depends on how these first few plays go. I mean, remember, they were pinned back on their last drive, and they moved the ball right down the field with a lot of tempo and an aggressive attack. It surprised me if they don't do that with 2 minutes to go in those timeouts.
Baxter. He'll be wrestled down after a very short gain there. Deontay Lawson has had a good first half.
Goes out of bounds there.
Inside,
I said,
2 minutes.
I think 13-3 lead being penned back inside there. Like I said, I think how these first couple plays go are going to impact what Sark's going to do. I don't know if he's necessarily thrilled that ball went out of bounds.
But he's Briggs being aggressive. Looks to be really aggressive. They attack. They got a bunch of dudes in the backfield. Now Sanders motions out. Two back look. Ewers back to throw. Flips it across the middle and it's incomplete. Low throw. Sanders couldn't get down for it. And now the clock stops again. It's 3rd and 9.
Good job by getting pressure. Only rushed 3. Had a late rusher there at the end, but he was off balance. One of the few times we've seen Ewers off balance trying to throw a football, and I think it impacted his accuracy there. And if you're an Alabama fan, this is big. You got 3 timeouts. You got him at the 10-yard line. If this defense ever wants to step up, make a play, it's right here with 1:48 to go before the half.
Fake it, and a high throw. Worthy couldn't come out, so that one just got out of the hands of Ewers. Malachi Moore was in the area. It's a quick 3 and out. They used almost no time. And Sarkisian will give the football back to Alabama with plenty of time before the break.
Yeah, it shows you the confidence that he has in Ewers. Good pressure there. Even though you don't come up with a sack, you can affect the accuracy. You come in low to a quarterback, you could almost see him start to get down to protect himself as he was throwing that football. So the pressure impacts them on those last 2 plays.
Kool-Aid McKinstry drifts back. He's at his 45. Sanborn boots it away. That's a heck of a punt. Drives him all the way back to the 34. Coverage guys giving chase, and McKinstry will just get down. That was a tremendous clutch putt by Sanborn. There is a flag way back inside the 5, a 56-yard boot under pressure. Said it went over your new teammates. See what the flag is about.
Holding on the kicking team, number 13. That penalty is enforced from the end of the kick. First down. From the end of the run.
Have to add some yardage on after the kick. Holly?
Well, guys, after that missed opportunity from Quinn Ewers to get that first down, he came to the sideline and Sark just greeted him and said, hey, calm down, set your feet, set your feet. You saw that ball sail high. He wants his quarterback to get those feet in the right position so he has the best chance to be accurate on those throws.
Yeah, that was the only time we've seen him on that second down where his feet weren't settled. Jordan Whittington, at the snap of the ball, when Alabama was getting pressure, he tackled an Alabama defender before he could get in to pressure him. I'm surprised they're not going to breathe. This is a big punt. This is not necessarily, oh, you're going to get field position tapped on after.
Yeah, you know, they'll have the penalty yardage at the end, but it's still a hell of a punt to push him back.
Yeah, that was big.
Years ago, you had to take the penalty and go back and do it or decline it. Mm-hmm. Now they allow you to tack that on.
We'll get a few yards back here.
From the 38, minute 34, and all 3 timeouts. Flips across the middle. And catch is made by Kobe Prentice, his first tonight. Clock still moving.
Well, here's the look right here to the right. Pretty good tackle.
Straight up tackle.
Put that receiver, Whittington, on defense.
He lost a yard.
Minute 9
continues
running.
To move. They didn't spend the time out there. Texas 3-man rush, and they still harass Miller, who somehow escapes and will just sprint to the sidelines. Murphy had him in his grasp, couldn't control him, but it'll be 3rd down.
I'm surprised. I mean, they're only rushing 3, and they're able to get by with quickness that time. Miller, with his strength and speed, is able to get some yards, but right now this passing game, if you're Texas, does not feel like a threat at all. Downfield, nothing, allowing them to put a lot of their coverage short and intermediate.
Across the middle, catch made. Prentice, still loose. Kobe Prentice will be dragged down, but a huge play down to the 31. Alabama's first big spark on offense tonight.
Yeah, this time Crawford ends up getting surprised. Safeties get to the outside. It opens it up to the middle. Ball's got to be thrown on a line. And Crawford just unable to have awareness there to locate the football.
28 yards on 3rd and 8. Milroe escapes again. Man completely open is Prentice. They've forgotten about him. Woo! Makes a man miss and knocked down inside the 20.
the athletic ability to keep these plays alive, but it starts to be a little bit of improvising, almost backyard football. Great job of locating that open man.
It's this Olay.
Yeah, not only the first down, but great job of working inside and then back outside to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
So that big play on third and long has suddenly ignited this Bama passing game. Out of the backfield, that's Williams, who fell down. Certainly they'll spend one of the timeouts now. Yeah, got all three of them. 24 seconds, and it'll be second and four.
Sees Watts, the blitz. Good job of recognizing that. Gets it around Watts, who's on the blitz, and gets it out quickly there to Roydell Williams. He's able to put that on the money. He's probably going to walk into the end zone. There's nobody out there on him.
This game, not unlike last year's game. Texas had some opportunities to build a lead. They were up three, could have been more tonight. The strike was from 44 yards for the touchdown, but in the two red zone trips had to settle for field goals.
That's really the first time I think Texas felt threatened on that third down. They've been able to get a push without blitzing a lot. They've been slanting, moving some people, but that's been able to allow them to win the line of scrimmage. So they haven't felt threatened other than trying to contain Milroe with his creativity. But the pass game's not been a factor at all until that third down conversion.
Can Alabama punch it in? Cut the lead to three. McClellan goes in motion. Milroe looks that way, now picks it up, and he'll be tackled behind the line of scrimmage. Ethan Burks had a good first half.
What a job he does here. Remember, he's going up against a freshman, Proctor. He's right here. And he's kind of confused initially, but the fact that Milroe takes off, he took off right into the arms of Burke. That's one of the bad parts of a quarterback that wants to always try to get out and rely on his feet. It really wasn't necessarily on Proctor. It wasn't that Burke beat him. It was that Milroe stepped up and then right into the arms of the pick Burke at 6'6".
Good athlete. He was a lacrosse All-American. If you're good enough to be an All-American in high school, yep, at that sport, it shows you can move around. And he's got his first career sack last week against Rice. He's made a big impact here tonight in the first half.
Local product out of Westlake, one of the perennial powers in that great state of Texas for high school football.
Third and long again. 23 seconds left in the half. Milroe feels the pressure again, escapes it, tucks the ball, now thinks about throwing to the end zone, tipped, and caught in the carry for a touchdown. Jermaine Burton off the deflection. There is a flag down. However, there is a flag on the play.
Chris, I think you got linemen downfield. And when you quarterback runs around that much, you're going to have offensive linemen downfield.
Lineman downfield, number 71, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Don't know if they saw it, but Milroe actually tucked the ball, but he was about 15 yards behind the line of scrimmage. You can't blame him for thinking he was going to run.
Yeah, I mean, what a push, by the way, by Brout. Right there, somehow he fights out of it, keeps his speed alive. There's Sorrell diving, makes the throw. Offensive lineman downfield. He gets away with one. Jalen Ford should have come up with an interception. He had four last year. And it ends up being Darian Dalcourt, 71, who is downfield.
Surprised it did bounce off his hands. He's got seven takeaways in his last eight games. Four, five of them picks.
One of the more productive linebackers you'll see.
Clock is now a factor with 13 seconds to play. Third and 12. And another whistle and a flag before the snap. It's a false start. Tide misfiring down here in the red zone.
Illegal snap. Offense, number 56. 5-yard penalty. It's third down.
Alabama catches a break here because McLaughlin, this could have been a fumble. Quarterback's not ready. Watch the ball move. Moves, and then he snaps. Great recognition by the umpire and a break for Alabama.
Bounce right up Milroe's chest. Third and 17. Still in field goal range, but that's what they do here, trying to get a little bit closer, but they launch for the end zone. Milroe again on the move, taken off, a long way to run. Scoots out with 5 seconds to go. And we'll figure, send out the field goal team.
Yeah, Texas will take that. I think the frustrating thing is you got a quarterback right now in Jalen Milroe that as soon as he drops back to throw, he's getting out. He's not seeing coverage. He's relying on his feet. He's not even getting pressure. There wasn't a pass rush there, but he still wants to try to get out and try to create where he's more comfortable out on the edge of that defense. Puts a lot on his legs, and it reduces his field and choices.
Still was his best drive as a passer. He's 4 for his first 4. They move it 50 yards in 7 plays, and Reichert, ultra-reliable, cuts it to a 7-point lead at halftime. Sarkisian and the Longhorns controlling most of this first half, but not building the kind of lead they could have. Ali?
Well, Coach Sarkisian, it's crazy and chaotic out here, but how would you describe the composure of your quarterback in this first half that's trickled down to your team?
Well, I just think we're playing loose and free and confident football. You know, we missed a couple opportunities, but I like the mentality of our team. I like the way we're playing.
Jalen Milroe is difficult with his feet. You've been able to limit his throwing. How have you contained him so far?
Well, we haven't contained him good enough, okay? So we got to do a better job of securing our edges when we're rushing and squeeze that pocket a little bit more. But I love the way our defense is playing right now. We're getting some critical stops.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Holly.
And his quarterback play well. Quinn Ewers, 138 yards passing and the 44-yard strike to Xavier Worthy. The Longhorns lead it by a touchdown in Tuscaloosa at halftime. Time now for the Mercedes-Benz Halftime Report. Kick it back to our buddy Matt Berry and company. At the end of the first half before having to settle for 3.
Yeah, but he made the one big throw on third right. down, but a lot of it has been improvising and using his legs. I'm very interested to see what Tommy Rees said to him and how he's going to try to get him to just settle in and let the maybe quicker reads, easier reads. They've got to get their passing game going.
It was a very close quarterback competition with Milroe out-dueling Tyler Buckner, the transfer from Notre Dame. Keep that in mind. Her Mark of a Fighter brought to you by Modelo.
Yeah, what they've done on defense, a lot of times it's been about the pressure. They've picked their spots at the right time to bring linebackers like Benda. You can see that defensive line coming up with some sacks. First half, Milroe had his eyes on those white jerseys and worrying about pressure as much as reading coverage.
Yeah, pressured on more than half of his drops. McClellan tries to bounce it. He works hard to fall forward for about 3.
Remember, Alabama had a nice drive where they just, it was after the interception early in the half. They got behind that offensive line, and they had about 8 or 9 straight runs, and they moved the ball down the field. Now, some of that was some quarterback runs, some zone read, but they didn't throw the ball. They just relied on that running game. See what they do here as an adjustment.
And McClellan makes his way. He's going to be stopped about 4 yards short of the marker. Good tackle by Ryan Watts. So right out of the gate, a third medium.
And so Pete Kwiatkowski, the defensive coordinator from Texas, right now he doesn't feel very threatened by anything downfield. So what he's telling his linebackers and those safeties is until they make us pay for it, let's get aggressive. Let's get downhill. Let's take away that quarterback run. Let's take away their run game. Let's outnumber them at the line of scrimmage. Not here on third down, but on those early downs.
You know they'll have their eyes on number 4 in this third down. Milroe from the pocket launches downfield looking for Bond, and Isaiah Bond makes a diving catch. He does throw the deep ball well. It's the best thing he does as a thrower. Big play there.
Yeah, it is. You can see it in the warm-ups. Great one-on-one matchup. They get man-to-man coverage. Chris, you're right. There's not a read here. It's just drop back, get your feet underneath you, and throw it up in the air. We saw him in pregame. You and I both were like, wow, he throws a beautiful deep ball. It's a simple read, and it can show you the arm strength.
Looking for this wide receiver group to break out and have an impactful season. Bond is one of the best deep threats. And now McClellan, your first down run. Good determination to make something of it. Got 3.
Love how this kid runs. I mean, he runs hard. McClellan, a guy, again, is a veteran that's been around. He's from the state of Texas. Look how determined he is. I mean, he is using everything that he has to keep his balance and push that Texas defense. Didn't get a ton of yards, but you send a message when you run the football like that for your offensive line.
We had the biggest impactful play for the Texas offense, or against the Texas defense, a year ago, the 81-yard touchdown on Austin. Milroe chased. Flag is out as he scrambles and now flips the ball. Does he be on the line of scrimmage? The catch is made by Burton. There's a lot going on. He's going to score. But let's see. There was a flag way back in the holding zone.
Tyler Booker, the left guard, I think, was holding. There's a lot going on here.
I mean, the flag came out early. I thought he might have crossed the line of scrimmage.
Offense, number 74. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. It is.
Look at that. He's the uber-talented first opening day true freshman starter at left tackle since Cam Robinson.
And they called on Proctor, but look at the left guard. He's holding 95. You got both guys on that left side end up coming up with a hold. And again, when a quarterback's mobile, when he moves around, those defensive linemen have their eyes on him. They're moving. And Milroe's not the traditional drop-back guy, so as he moves, those defensive linemen move, and those linemen are put in tough spots.
Penalties, again, impactful. Wiped out a couple of Alabama touchdowns tonight. Snap, he wasn't ready for it. Was this another one of those illegal snaps?
Yeah, he moved that ball again. Second time, center McLaughlin.
Illegal snap on the offense, number 56. 5-yard penalty, second half.
McLaughlin, one of the leaders there. He's a senior, Georgia, steady guy, but
see that,
you know, a little jumpy tonight.
Yeah.
And again, when he moved the ball and snapped it, Milroe wasn't ready for it.
Well, that's the cadence, that's the rhythm of the offense. McLaughlin is a veteran guy, played a lot of football.
Second and 22 after the second penalty. They get it out in the perimeter to Prentice, who made a big impact in that final drive of the first half. They get some of it back, but it's still going to be third and 13.
On the last third down, they found a great matchup where they got Bond one-on-one against a nickel Barron. See if Texas gets out of that man coverage. Looks like more of a zone. Showing pressure up front.
They don't bring it, though. Only a three-man rush. And Milroe still has to escape the pocket. He's going to be dragged down. So they drop eight in coverage. Doesn't make the throw. Anthony Hill makes the tackle. And it's fourth down.
Yeah, they're showing the pressure. They end up dropping. They're playing zone here. And here's your spy. His only job on third down is keep an eye on that quarterback. He's a freshman linebacker. He can run. You cannot let him get outside of you. He does, but he's able to catch up to him to bring him down.
Here comes Will Reichard. This is from 51 yards, a yard short of his career long. He's accounted for all of the Bama points so far. Very reliable long-distance kicker. Certainly has the leg for this. Whips it up.
Bama coach Nick Saban at the half. And, guys, he was so intense. He said, we are just not executing. I asked him, how could they gain more continuity on offense? He said, we've got to execute. We've run the football well. We've got to get back to doing that. We saw them do that on that last drive. They have run the ball well, but the mistakes keep stalling drives. One other thing to keep your eye on, Caleb Downs, their phenomenal freshman safety. He is on the sideline. He's lost his lunch. He's not doing well. Not sure if he can return to this game.
Is it an official medical term?
Yes.
Now, this is Keelan Robinson. Make a return. The first kick return tonight. It's out to the 23.
Milroe trying to talk to Tommy Reese when he came over. They're just trying to get on the same page, wondering, you know, the adjustments that they want to make. You know, this conversation continues from halftime. You can see Tommy Reese trying to figure out the best way to attack and finish off these drives.
Head and hand says a lot. They did come away with three in the drive. And at times last year, even with Bryce Young, Bama's offense was super frustrated. They punted seven straight possessions before the quarterback made some magic in the fourth quarter. Texas now back to work. And the freshman is tackled behind the line. Terrion Arnold got Baxter, who loses about four.
Good job here by Arnold. He's able to get inside the receiver, Mitchell, with that quickness. He may have been coming there in kind of that run blitz, bringing pressure off the boundary. Remember earlier, he made a big play in space, prevented a touchdown by Texas. This time comes up, gets him behind the sticks.
Rushing game has not been very productive for Texas tonight. 43 on the ground. Second and 15 to get it to the perimeter quickly. This is an effective way to use Baxter, who gets back near the original line of scrimmage, but it's going to be third and long. Boston knocked them down.
And you get to that third and long. Alabama has a chance to get guys on and off the field. It's six defensive backs. For Kevin Steele and Nick Saban like to dial it up, see if they try to bring some kind of pressure.
Horns have been pretty solid on third down tonight, considering the opposition, but this is tough, needing 11. Four-man rush, Ewers steps up, flips it away, it's just over the head of Whittington, who had some space, and the Tide defense come up with a three and out.
They just bring four, but they're able to get great pressure. Chris Braswell is coming off from the right side. Here's your receiver, works across. Pretty impressive by Ewers to climb this pocket. Up into the pocket, keeps it just enough time alive, and puts it up in the air. I thought Whittington at 6'1 would climb and make that play. Looked like both hands on it.
Ryan Sanborn's been clutch tonight on the run to his right. Boots it away from Kool-Aid McKinstry. A flag is down as the ball rolls dead at the 30. 49-yard punt. Flag is back near midfield.
During the kick, holding. Return team, number three. 10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. It is first down.
It's Tyrion Arnold. It's going to be the seventh penalty on the Crimson Tide. Not as bad as last year's game. The Tide fans thinking, not again. Yeah. He is a tackler by trade.
What's this?
Whoa! What? Has your name always been Hulu Has Live Sports?
I guess so.
New name, same man. Meet Jalen, Hulu Has Live Sports.
It's on me. I got y'all. Yes, sir.
Hulu Plus Live TV, your place to watch live TV.
Some people just know there's a podcast about that. Those are the people who know to choose Allstate.
Big tea drinker.
Yeah.
There's a podcast about tea.
He knows, hey. And he wants you to know, too.
I was listening to a podcast on if dogs know their dogs.
There's a podcast about that?
Just like he'd want you to know about Allstate.
There's a podcast about fly fishing called Why Is That Person Doing That? It's called Terrific.
Are you listening to a podcast?
Yeah, it's about multitasking.
Some people just know there's a podcast about that. Those are the people who know you're in good hands with Allstate.
Baby, it's over.
I mean, we both saw this coming.
I'm sorry.
What a difference a day makes. 24 little hours.
ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by IHG Hotels and Resorts, is brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Local Chick-fil-A restaurants recognized the University of Alabama Athletics ground and campus maintenance crews earlier this week with a catered meal to thank them for all they do.
Appreciate our blimp crew providing aerial coverage, courtesy of Goodyear, celebrating the challenge of road games everywhere. Are you ready for the road? Goodyear more driven. Texas so far ready for this road challenge, as Milroe's going to launch downfield, and out comes the flag. That was Gavin Holmes tied up with Bond, who made the big play earlier. Don't know if he had a chance to make the play. It's a mistake by the Longhorn secondary.
Ferris, defense, number 9, 15-yard penalty. First down.
Clearly, Milroe's comfortable throwing the deep ball. Had 3 touchdowns against Rice that were all long balls. This year in the young season, you go beyond 30, he's 3 of 4. It's an outstanding percentage.
Yeah, I think he held on to that ball a little bit too long and allowed Bond to get downfield. They get the pass interference, but he had about 3 hitches there waiting for the coverage to really dictate itself before he threw that ball. I think Bond outran his arm, but they'd catch the break there with the interference.
First catch of the night, Jamarian Miller, sophomore out of Texas. From Tyler, as a matter of fact, famous hometown of Earl Campbell. He impressed him in scrimmages by busting off some big runs. So he does have a home run gear.
Everybody you talk to since we've been here the last couple days, we start asking about the backs, and all they want to talk about, you talk about the veterans, but right away they get excited about Haynes and especially Miller based on those scrimmages. Every day ripping off big runs.
Goes by Jam. He's getting a turn here. Midway second quarter, got the football again. Tries to bounce it. That is an outstanding tackle by Keaton Crawford, the free safety, in the open field.
And this is part of the youth of a young back who's usually in high school, been able to bounce this and outrun a safety. Here in the college game against a really talented safety like this, you just can't do that. You can't always bounce. And that's something that young backs learn as they get up against better competition, that if it's not there, you're better off just lowering that shoulder and trying to get 2 or 3 instead of trying to bounce it wide.
Here we go again. Third down for the tie. They need 4. Low snap. Milroe scoops it up. Launches downfield. And he had McClellan out of the backfield wide open. Bender was given chase. That was a touchdown if it wasn't overthrown.
Tommy Reese calls this perfectly. Ball's a little bit low. Here's the matchup right here. Man to man. It's a really good job here of dialing this up. Gets downfield, up in the air, a little bit more air, and that's a big play.
Well, Tommy Reese, dialed up a play that obviously he feels comfortable throwing, and that was a missed opportunity, and Texas will get the football back. Burn it. High boot. And Worthy makes the fair catch at the 6-yard line. It's about 5.5 seconds of hang time, says Mike Black. That's even more than Ewers had on the throw downfield before.
And in a game like this, I mean, look at this score. It's, who thought 13-9 in the third quarter? But they pinned them again inside this, down what are they, about the 5-yard line.
Both offenses have been pinned back and had to deal with poor field position at times tonight.
The umpire gets run over there.
Looks like Coots ran into him at full speed. He's just doing his job, trying to keep his eye on the play. Like he might have been cut in the face a little bit.
Bill, when something like this happens, obviously you hope he's able to go. The trainer looking at him. What happens in this situation?
Well, they do have an alternate official, so an alternate official could come in.
They're playing
ball.
They're
checking for 2 things. He's got the cut. They might want to check him for some concussion protocol.
Yep.
He got nailed pretty good.
He did.
Meanwhile, another crucial situation for Ewers to take care of the football down here. They're going to throw it on first down. They launch it one-on-one. Going up to make the catches. Adonai Mitchell. Wow! Contested, and he beat Kool-Aid McKinstry.
Oh, great route. Hey. Are you kidding me with the throw? How about yours? How about Sark calling this? Throws the football up in the air and over top of the corner. Great job.
Goes at their best DB. Yours. Oh, they suck a man wide open, and it's Sanders. Eludes a man. Oh, just stumbled down. McKinstry just got enough of him to bring him down, but the Longhorns are clicking inside the 30.
Sark saved a few plays here. That time Sanders lined up on the right. He gets completely lost in coverage as he works back to the left. Nobody picks him up.
Chunks of 32 and 34. Hand off on the right side to Baxter. Saved some plays his right.
that misdirection. Sark trying to affect the eyes every single week. He gets ready, and he's trying to attack those safeties and backers with different looks. That time he slid Sanders. It opened up beautifully.
The play fake. Ewers pitches it, but all over Gunnar Helm, the tight end. And coverage there was Deontay Lawson. Let's go back to that. He's in his end zone. It's a precarious position, Kirk. They're up four against Alabama, and he lets him take a pitch against the best DB on the field.
Well, it's very important when you watch college football all day, how many coaches in a game like this trust their quarterback to make not just the right decision, but an accurate throw. It's either going to make that catch or it's going to be out of bounds. He's a different guy from where he was a year ago.
Needs six. Keep the drive going. Pressure picked up. Worthy goes up in the end zone and could not come up with it. Trey Amos knocked the ball loose. No hesitation.
He knock it loose? Because I thought it got over top of his hands and into the arms. I think it got over top of Amos. I mean, that would have been a great catch. Don't get me wrong. Yeah, that cleared his hand and somehow got down into the receiver.
And Amos was able to swipe it with the hand coming down. So from 42, Bert Auburn tries to stay perfect on the night. It's hooking, and he missed it. So the Longhorns, stellar clutch kicker, misses his first of the night. The lead is still four in Tuscaloosa, midway third.
Rockies, Giants, an NL West battle on Sunday Night Baseball.
The one thing we can never get more of is time. Or can we? This is Watson X Orchestrate, AI designed to multiply productivity by auto.
Favor. Take it out of the monitor. Alabama still down only four. Milroe tried to fire it across the middle. It was at the feet.
He had an open man. I like the play call on first and 10. Play action with his Texas defense being overly aggressive, expecting the run. Caught him up close to the line. If he could layer that ball right over top of the safety, he had a nice gain, but unable to throw it accurately.
Second and 10 run by Radell Williams. Smacked, and then Texas goes downhill. Murphy made the initial contact to slow him down. Third and long now for Milroe.
We keep revisiting this defensive line from Texas, rotating. That time it was Byron Murphy, probably the most disruptive defensive lineman. Even though Sweat 93 gets a lot of attention, Collins making plays, Broughton making plays.
Casey Hampton.
Yeah.
He's kind of like
that
in the
feel
Texas
to him.
Mold. He's
yeah.
Strongest dude on the team. Milroe is an empty backfield. And that's a flag. It's going to get even tougher now. Lynch on the right side of the line.
Right tackle.
Ball start. Offense, number 65. 5-yard penalty.
I mean, whether you win or you lose, this is exactly week two how you're going to drive Nick Saban crazy. It happened last year in Austin. It's happening again. Miscues. When they go back and evaluate this game, they're going to see critical mistakes. Up at the top there, that time it was Latham. These are veteran guys.
You're talking about an unforced error.
And you go from 3rd and 10, which is already tough enough, to now 3rd and 15.
Pocket collapsing, and they've got him. Anthony Hill Jr., that speedy freshman, making an impact tonight and a huge stop for Texas.
Now, he got in for the spring as a true freshman out of Denton, Ryan High School, far right, matched up against another true freshman. Nice bend, able to get around the big tackle. That tackle is Proctor, 360 pounds. It's great to have size, but on 3rd and 15, you better have some quickness and move those feet and those hands. Freshman against freshman, and Hill wins it.
When you say bend, the defensive player has bend. It's
nice
bend.
Bend.
And the punt is not good off the foot. It does take a favorable bounce for Barnett. We'll see where they spot it. 47-yard end of working out okay. Sunday NFL countdown, week one. Professional football is back. John McEnroe went down and sat with Aaron Rodgers. He talked about the interesting thing. Yeah, Johnny Mac was saying he enjoyed that. Revealing all-access look at the Dolphins head coach Mike McDaniel. Plus all the injury updates. Everything you need to preview every game. 10 Eastern.
Time's your match tomorrow with Johnny Mac.
4 Eastern.
Looking forward to that.
Djokovic Medvedev for the
U.S. Great.
Congratulations, Coco Gauff. What a huge win today.
That's great.
U.S. tennis. The teenager wins her first major. Take it to Brooks. Yours looking across the middle, and it's incomplete. Waiting for the football was Mitchell, but Arnold arrived to knock it loose.
It's been an up-and-down night for Arnold, right? I mean, he's made some plays, and he's made some mistakes. This time, he does a good job of reacting. Once that ball's in the air, times that up really well. As soon as it looked like Mitchell might be able to come up with a big gain, and another first and 10 throw, by the way, by Ewers. Sark really dialing up there on those early downs. He's able to dislodge that ball.
And they'll run it off the left side on second down, and Brooks almost broke it. They stop him a yard short of the marker there. Caleb Downs made the tackle. Now it's 3rd and just 1.
Slow developing counter play. Going to follow around that right guard, Hudson, and also the tight end, Sanders.
Playing with tempo. He plowed forward. He didn't get it. But they tried to catch Alabama. Not ready for that 3rd and 1. Deontay Lawson stuffed him. That could be a crucial stop against Sark's offense.
And give credit to Bama's defense. There's been some times, as you say, they don't have their cleats in the ground. That time, almost anticipating that hurry up on 3rd down, they did. And Lawson able to attack down and keep him short.
How about this decision, Kirk? Minus 48, up 4, 4th down. And they're going to try to sneak it with a push of the ball. She goes to Brooks. He juggled it, held on, and they moved the sticks.
That ball came out.
Yeah.
Ball came out.
He just scooped
it up. Not only is he short, that's a fumble. The timing of that just felt off. That ball went through his legs. Somehow, you got Brooks who looks down, but he never had it. Never had the football.
We're going to discuss whether he was down before the ball came
loose. How can you be down when he didn't have it? He didn't have the ball.
What? First of all, I wasn't convinced they're actually going to run a play. I thought they might try to draw him offside. Bill, what are you seeing there?
I have a muff ball, so anybody can pick it up and run with it. Had it been a fumble on 4th down,
yeah,
only the person that fumbled it could advance it. So being that this is a muff, no possession,
yep,
anybody can
That's
pick
huge.
It up on the offense.
Look at the ball. Watch the ball. Tell me if you ever see that. You could see it bouncing around. Anytime a center on a sneak, he starts to reach.
The ruling on the field, it was a fumble, yep, by the quarterback. The ball was recovered beyond the line, but the ball will be returned due to the 4th down play. It will be returned to the fumble. It'll be Alabama's ball.
Well, this is not, Bill, the way you see it. This is an enormous decision on the field. Alabama will have it in plus territory if this call stands. Is that something they can look at in replay, whether the quarterback had possession, Bill?
Possession is reviewable.
Sark, I think, sees it the way you do, Bill. And by the way, he talked about a huge moment in this game. I don't think I just don't think he ever had the football.
You know, and I go back to what possession is. I don't care if it's a pass, a kick.
And you can see the ball right there.
He never had it. Hands.
And again, you're talking about a quarterback sitting in the shotgun 90% of the time. You know, you got to stay with the center on a sneak, and that ball came out.
David Almond is the replay official for this SEC crew. They work with the headquarters in Birmingham, but the decisions will be made here, along with Matt Leffler, the referee. Again, possession, if it's reviewable, what specifically, Bill, are they looking at to determine whether he had it long enough?
I look for the same thing I do on a pass. You've got to have firm control of the ball. You got to be able to do a football move. He hasn't done any of that.
Bill, is there enough here to overturn this?
I say there's enough.
It's because you want to be right, right? I mean, I'm just kidding. No.
Well, the ball came, it hit about three different legs before.
Billy, here's a good look for you right here. This is going to be your look.
No, he's pulling his hands away without the ball. This is one of the weirdest replays you've ever seen in an incredibly impactful situation in the game. It's either Texas ball.
Ever possessed.
It's either Texas ball with a first down in Alabama territory or Bama ball in Texas territory.
Bill's rules.
After review,
that's first down Texas.
The quarterback never gained possession of the ball. Therefore, it's a backward pass, which can be advanced. Yeah. It was advanced beyond the line of gain. It's a first down for Texas.
That's why Billy's up here. Set the straight. Out of bay, Bill.
Probably better up here than I was on the field, maybe.
Well, that's a huge play. And you made the right call there at the beginning. We could see on the replay he never had possession. Good job there by Brooks to pick it up. And Texas keeps his drive alive.
An incredible piece of good fortune. And alert play by Brooks. They tried to rush up and go for it in third and short. Didn't get it. Tried to sneak from about a yard and a half away. Now Ewers, batted. No, it's right back to him. Weird stuff is happening. The quarterback on the reception will scamper out of bounds for 5 yards. What's going to happen next?
How about Lawson? He times that up. The backer knocks it down. Most quarterbacks are taught just knock the ball down. Ewers lost all this weight, so he said, I'm just going to catch it and take off and run. We've seen him use his legs a few times tonight.
Brooks. He made that alert scoop. That could end up being one of the biggest plays of this game if Texas comes out on top. Runs it down there, third and short again now.
Texas keeps working the edges. Sark knows how tough it is between the tackles, but doing a good job of mixing up these looks.
Ewers has time, but it's incomplete. Trying to get it to Mitchell in heavy traffic. Now it's fourth and two. From the 42.
Go back to what Sark said before the game, halftime with Holly. We came in here to win. We have an aggressive mindset. That's who we are. Boy, is he living up to that here on these last two fourth downs if he decides to go here again.
He sure is. He's also got a defense that's not allowed a touchdown tonight. You could pin him back. Head coach putting it on the line. And Brooks fighting. I don't think he got there. Dallas Turner wrapped him up. And this time it is going to be a turnover on downs. Boy, the side just ran in. I thought he was clearly short. And it is short. Alabama football.
Watch Turner. Watch him come all the way over. Doesn't even really get set. Blows Sanders up and makes the play of the night for Alabama. Lawson helped cleans it up. That was a remarkable effort. Turner had the big play last year on a sack against Ewers. Here, fourth down and short. Pushes Sanders, the tight end, and then Rapp gets off that block. That is a remarkable effort by a guy who's known as a pass rusher. That time makes a play to defend the run.
Leader on this defense. He has been tutored by the great Will Anderson in his career. Was that an improv play? You think he just decided to go over?
No, I think he reacted late to the alignment and got in position to make a play.
Rodell Williams. There'll be some grumbling in this crowd. They definitely want to see the run game reestablished, but they're getting a little impatient with this offense. Piled up 237. That's it.
I got to keep looking. It's 13-9. You know, it feels like Texas is up by a couple scores. But Alabama's kind of hanging in there defensively. Texas has missed some big opportunities where they've been in plus territory, haven't been able to come away with points. And we got a four-point game here late in the third.
Running on second and long, McClellan can't escape for long. Ethan Burke, another tackle. Third and six. There's some grumbling from the faithful of Tuscaloosa here.
They're frustrated by this conservative approach. Watch Sweat here, 93, right in the middle. Big man, 362, works through that double team and affects the timing of that play. You know, we talked with Seth McLaughlin, the center, yesterday, and he said, man, the double team's going to be everything against the size of this Texas defensive front. That time, Sweat wins.
I'm going to hold off 600 pounds and have that be your job description. He just did it there. Milroe escaping the pocket, tries to get there with his legs, and he does. Scamper for a first down in Texas territory. Bender was giving chase, but it's a fresh set.
Well, the big thing they talked about is not getting out of their lanes. Here's a freshman that got out of his rush lane. Off to the right, he gets upfield. You can't get upfield beyond the quarterback. When you do, now he's got a lane. And with that speed, he's going to be able to beat you to the corner for a first down. Look at this rush lane open up. If that freshman, number zero, if he would have squeezed, kept him in a pocket, that would not have happened.
Play fake. Milroe immediately pressured. Came flying off the edge, eventually tackled behind the line. Keaton Crawford got there in a heartbeat.
He did a really good job of disguising it. I don't think Milroe anticipated it, saw it. McClellan actually sees it late, but not soon enough to be able to help. But somehow, Jalen Milroe, with that athletic ability, is at least able to avoid a disaster.
Milroe again has to elude pressure, launches downfield, and it's caught for a touchdown by Jermaine Burton. They waited three quarters finally for this Alabama pass game to really come to life. 49-yard strike from Milroe to Burton, and Bama has its first lead.
Well, we've talked so much about Sark, how he draws plays, what he does before the snap, and how it helps him create matchups. Well, Alabama fans, Tommy Rees just showed you what he can do as well by creating a matchup.
And Jermaine Burton, the Georgia transfer, six touchdowns now in his last six games.
Alabama fans, you just said murmurs, booing. Bond right here is going to come in motion. Right now you got a corner on the best receiver from Alabama. Watch what happens with the motion. That corner's now, because of Bond in motion, he's now going to be taking Bond right here. Now you're going to get Burton matched up right here, which is exactly what you want, with a safety. So by using the motion, you take the corner off of your best receiver and you get him matched up in a mismatch against a safety in Jaren Thompson, who cannot stay with him one-on-one. And what a throw. He had time to make it. Milroe throws his best ball, which is a deep ball, right over the shoulder for the touchdown.
We were joking with Saban pregame after watching Milroe complete beautiful deep ball after beautiful deep ball. I said, I think he's just go bombs away. Or you just throw.
That's his ball.
And he kind of laughed. I don't, maybe we weren't kidding.
No. I mean, between his scrambles and the deep ball, that's, and then you mix in some of the run game, that's where they are right now. And as far as the comfort zone of this offense, week two.
And as you said, it just felt like Texas should have made more of their opportunities to build a bigger lead. Now they're down by three. closing into the fourth quarter. To Matt Barry.
All right, gentlemen, you know better than anyone. Weird stuff can happen in Lubbock on a Saturday night. This is Tyler Shough, former Oregon quarterback, now the starter for Texas Tech, takes it in, gives them the lead. Later, Shough to Jerran Bradley, and right now, Texas Tech up on Oregon, 27-18.
Feeling about that?
Yeah, I do. Once in a while, you stumble into one.
Now, Ewers. And this Texas offense has to respond. This place is louder than it's been all night. On the pop pass, Keelan Robinson's going to be knocked down after about a five-yard gain, and it should be the last play of this third quarter. Crimson Tide get a field goal after penalties spoil one drive, and then the 49-yard strike. Milroe to Burton.
You're watching the Allstate Crossbar Classic.
Glad you're with us. This presentation of the SEC on ESPN. Final quarter. Texas behind for the first time tonight, facing a second and seven. Ewers. He takes a downfield shot. And ball falls to the ground. There's a flag as Mitchell was going out there and just got grabbed in coverage.
A second time we've seen Arnold just hold on after Mitchell's gotten behind him. Like I said, it's been an up and down night for Terrion Arnold.
Pass interference on the defense, number three. 15-yard penalty. Result,
see so many of these because a 15-yard penalty is a lot better than what probably would have happened if he hadn't grabbed the receiver.
Yeah, he loses his balance, but again, he's holding on to that jersey.
Moves the ball to the 43.
How much does this game feel like last year? What was it, 13-10 at the end of the third quarter last year?
Feels like penalties are a big factor, too. Ninth for Alabama. Ewers still has it and finds his tight end, Sanders. Big man, rumbling free, gets a block, stiff arm. Lowers the shoulder. What a run after the catch for this athletic tight end from Texas.
Boy, does this open up off after the play fake. Baxter, the freshman, goes out into the flat. Watch Baxter go out into the flat right here. And watch how he pulls the defense with him. Right here, those two defenders both kind of come up, opened it up nicely right behind it.
50-yard chunk. Sets up first and goal. Play fake. Ewers. Slant. Touchdown, Mitchell. What a response by Texas. Bama scores the first touchdown of the night. Texas trails for the first time. Three plays, 75 yards. How do you do to reclaim the lead?
Caleb Downs, the freshman, who's going to be a superstar. He has his eyes in the backfield. What I love here is watch Ewers wait for the right time. Let him clear the freshman, and he throws it right behind him for that touchdown.
Mitchell made an impact as a Georgia Bulldog against Alabama and has certainly done so here tonight. Xavier Worthy, Jatavion Sanders, Whittington, Baxter, Mitchell. They got some playmakers for Quinn Ewers to pitch the football to. It's Texas back on top by four.
You're going to have to care about everything more than anything.
Wrexham as a club are the underdogs.
You know what happens in moments of life and death is that everything comes into focus.
Enjoy this.
Can I see the screen?
One moment.
What is it wherever you go, death follows?
Maybe fate brought you here for a reason.
What a rip.
I'm a winner!
Welcome to the future.
Now we're speaking the same language.
Did we just get hustled?
There's no way they were 70.
Interesting.
Hmm.
It's both an electric and a gas car.
Yep.
Quite the paradox.
So JJ's for lunch?
Electric for short trips, gas for long. It really is both. The first ever Lexus RX plug-in hybrid.
With college football on ESPN Plus, you get the best teams and the biggest conferences, and so much college football action from across the country. So sign up now at ESPNplus.com.
Hey, Jamie.
Oh, what am I up to? Just visiting a special secret client. I can't say who it is, but let's just say she bundled her dream house and her dream car for round-the-clock protection with Progressive. Oh. She has another house in Malibu. She's been an astronaut, an architect, a CEO.
We're in front of her house, dude.
Well, I'd love to tell you who her boyfriend is, but I don't think I can. I'd love to tell you, but I don't think I can.
Barbie, in theaters now.
Me and Bob met about 20 years ago here at Firestone.
I've learned over my life to find people that know what they're doing.
Working on cars is my passion and my love.
Helping our neighbors since 1926. Firestone Complete Auto Care.
Some streaks on the line here. Bama hasn't lost at home since Joe Burrow, the Bayou Bengals, came in here in 2019.
What a game.
21 in a row is the longest in FBS. Haven't lost a non-conference game since Saban's first year. A shocker. Texas last beat him in 82. Well, what did Sark say, Kirk? I want my team stand to the center thing, throw haymakers. That was a haymaker. They just took one, and then they just landed
right back. Came right back.
Lefty Stone boots it away. And Wobble will let it bounce. Well, we talked about the parallels to last year's Classic in Austin. You know, Bryce Young and the Tide come out. They were frustrated for most of the day on offense. Early on in this game, Ewers was planted in the ground by Dallas Turner on a personal foul, knocked out. And in the end, Bryce Young escapes that sack. That was the biggest play. Reichert knocks it through. It was a, quote, moral victory for Sarkisian at that point, he said, but it still really stunk.
And I think they grew that day, and they're not into moral victories in Austin, but I really think as a program in his second year, it enabled them. They ended up 8-5. Every loss they had was by a touchdown or less. I think it gave them confidence coming into tonight, and you got to love Sark and the culture on display tonight, battling in year three.
Bill Rowe delivers right into the hands of a Longhorn. Intercepted by Jared Thompson, his second mistake. He steps out inside the 10. That is a disastrous play for Milrow, his second pick tonight.
Thompson doesn't do anything fancy to disguise. He's right here. I just don't think Milrow, coming off that play action, got his eyes on him. He never saw him. I mean, again, he thinks he's got a one-on-one opportunity to throw that ball out to Burton, and instead he throws it right into the arms of Thompson, who's just sitting there. He does a good job of reacting, reading the eyes. He kind of telegraphed it, brought him over.
Burton hustled back to save a touchdown, but Thompson says, what? The ball's in my chest? Thank
you. I'll take it. Pete Kwiatkowski, the defensive coordinator, fired up about that turnover.
Now we got suddenly a huge sequence for Alabama's defense. They had the lead a minute ago. Now Texas trying to punch it in to stretch this to double digits. Worthy in motion. Brooks fights to the end zone, and Texas quickly cashes in to build the lead. What an incredible turnaround in the last few plays.
Heck of a job of executing up front. Good effort here by Brooks. There was some initial penetration. the leg drive here, the balance, and the progressive pylon cam showing you he gets up and over before that knee touches. But there were some really good blocks up front.
It's been hard to gain yards on this Alabama front on the ground tonight. Kind of a strange looking play. It was a delay, but he was patient and then powers his way in. And Sarkisian and crew lead by 11 now, 13:50 to play.
Just watch up front here, Christian Jones, the right tackle. Look at that push right there. See, good push. Campbell gets up to the second level. Good effort there, running there by Brooks, and they're in the end zone for a touchdown.
Two touchdowns in 15 seconds.
We're surprising Twisted Tea superfans with a Twisted Tea drop. Twisted Tea tastes like real iced tea because it's made with real brewed tea and 5% alcohol to kick off your game day. Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Keep it twisted.
To be there, to be there with AT&T 5G.
I used to watch the Heisman House every year on TV, and I'd always wonder, is it real? It's very real.
Take a little bit more up top.
Now that I've been here a while, it's a lot like campus. We have roommates.
Hey, Caleb, just try and keep it down. It's nap time.
Of course there's a gym.
10.
All right, people, here we go. Looking good, RG3.
No, you're looking good, RG3.
Yeah, so it's a lot
we need
like...
Room, rookie.
We're doing a tiki-tok.
Just like campus.
Hi, this is Chantrese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Honey Pepper Pimento Chicken Sandwich is the richness of the pimento cheese. No, actually, the mild spiciness of the jalapeno peppers. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Hey, my name's Liam, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Honey Pepper Pimento Chicken Sandwich is that it's so creamy. The pimento cheese has the great flavor, but it also lets everything else on the sandwich elevate it. That takes it up to another level. It's the best.
I'm your football-obsessed best man, and I think you having your big day during the big game is the worst. What, are you kidding me?
Physically, I'm right here, but mentally, I'm here. Yeah, I do. Come on, speed it up. When all eyes are on you, my eyes are glued to the game. Whoa! Touchdown, yeah! And if you didn't bundle your home and auto insurance, well, this could be tough to tackle. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Like me.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by IHG Hotels and Resorts. 18 hotel brands, one loyalty program. Download the app. And in part by Allstate, proud sponsor of the Allstate Crosspark Classic.
Wow, what a last few minutes here. These folks are stunned. Alabama got their first lead of the night and led for exactly 1 minute and 9 seconds before Texas responded. The pick and the one play touchdown drive, and suddenly the margin is 11 in the fourth quarter. Well, the Allstate bus is here at the Allstate Crossbar Classic, helping us with all the action today. Here, what's the Allstate good hands play?
Well, I think a huge game today was Miami and Texas A&M. It really went back and forth, but Tyler Van Dyke had a monster game, 374 through the air, 5 touchdowns on the afternoon, and the Canes and Mario Cristobal needed a big win. And this is a big win in year two for this program. They go to 2-0 and build some great momentum heading into week three.
Canes fans also don't mind seeing Jimbo Fisher take the L. All right, there is some urgency now. Double digit deficit. And Milroe will launch downfield, looking for Bond, who laid out, but it was just over the speedster's fingers.
Milroe took a big hit there. Was able to get that ball off, threw it pretty accurately, but there's that Texas front again, working to get off blocks. Boom, hits him right there. way. Pretty good ball considering he's getting a lot of pressure. Murphy hits him just before, just after he releases that ball.
Hit by the strongest guy on the team who plays with a nasty edge. Well, again, it'll be dropped. There's a flag in the pocket there. Ethan Burke has had a monster night. The sophomore from right there in Austin.
Well, it looked like they started to call it, but they picked it up. I'm with you. Again, the left tackle.
He did pick up a flag.
He pulled him down. He pulled Burke down. Proctor watch at the top. Good push here again by Burke. See, Proctor, he does his best to try to bring him down.
He took him down right into the quarterback's foot.
Well, I'll tell you what, he wanted to throw it. It was holding. But he's got a sack there. Yeah, it's not going to have any effect.
Yeah,
so
yeah, I got you.
He ate the flag.
Yep.
Fourth sack by this Horns front. They have been all over Milroe tonight. They've pressured him a whole bunch of times. Another low snap, which he has to collect and fire over the middle. And this time the catch is made by Benson. Malik Benson with a big catch, desperately needed. First out of the 45.
Kobe Prentice, six. Watch him kind of clear it out. Takes some defenders, keeps those safeties back. Creates a nice opening there behind the linebacker, Jalen Ford, and in front of the safeties. A few times we've seen him where the pressure is the most on third and long. Make big throws into the middle of that Texas defense.
27 on third and 17. Milroe looking to throw again. Checks it down, and that's Prentice. He's been effective on those middle range crossing routes. Now it's inside the 40.
Well, he's bounced back from that pick. Does a good job on the read of Barron. Look to the left in the flat. 23. Kind of sits there. He comes up to the back. Boy, he's got a strong arm.
Arm strength never the issue. That's for sure. Wellen, heavy traffic on the right side. Jalen Ford has just been a leader on this defense, mentored by the great Derek Johnson. Just kind of setting the tone and what Sarkis about the culture in Austin. He's one of the tone setters.
Yeah, he is.
Great player.
Yeah, he talked about a legacy of his and his entire group of seniors. They wanted people to remember what they did for this program and trying to be a guy that's helping the younger players get this program headed in a great direction. What a mature. Sometimes you talk to guys, they just have a look about him. He's one of those guys that's kind of an old soul, takes his job very serious of being a leader.
Another low snap. Milroe scoops it up, has time, and delivers over the middle. And the catch is made by Nyblack, and he's getting to the end zone. Somehow eludes tacklers in Alabama. Not done yet. A quick strike. Not the finest moment for Texas defense tonight.
Let's go back to the fact that his ball's on the ground again. I mean, he loses it. You're thinking, oh no, what's going to happen? Composure, eyes downfield, and again into the teeth of that Texas defense to the tight end, Nyblack, who's an athletic, tough matchup type of tight end.
Isaiah Bond put a man on the ground with a physical block to help him get the final few yards. And now Alabama down by five, going for two. Haymakers back and forth now.
Gonna run him here.
And
Sark
like Texas, yeah, Texas came on the field. Valuing these few yards of this 2-point, the difference between the 5-point lead and the 3-point lead, spends a timeout.
Again, remember last week against Middle Tennessee, ball rolled past him, he picked it up and ran for a touchdown. You got to really respect how much he's been pressured. Sacked four times, balls on the ground. Every snap counts for this Bama offense. And he makes that throw on a night where it hasn't been great. Hadn't been great throwing the football. But we've seen him have some success in the middle. Those safeties are going wide. It's opening up the middle. That is a tough throw for a guy trying to get his confidence established as a passer. But he's made three big ones today, and that was for a touchdown.
Can a defense lose its focus when the ball is dropped like that? But Milroe didn't, but they seem to be asleep.
Well, you can get your eyes in a backfield.
Yeah.
You know, that when that ball is on the ground, usually it could affect the pass rush. But there's been openings in the middle on that defense. And Bama and Tommy Reese adjustment just trying to get the ball thrown in there. Those deep crossers.
Now let's see what Reese has worked on. two-point plays. McClellan in the backfield. Milroe scanning, and he just flips it up into the air, and the catch is made, and the conversion is good. It's Isaiah Bond. Three-point game now.
What an effort to come down with a critical two-pointer to get this game within three. That was picked up.
Your first home sees a lot of firsts. From first loves to first steps. Sure, it can be a handful at times, keeping you up at night.
Come on now.
But with help from the Home Depot,
thank you very much.
You'll find the confidence to create the first place you call your own. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
Officially, it's a fridge full of beer. Unofficially, it's free AC. Coors Light, the official beer of everything unofficial.
There are people who say things aren't made here anymore. Those people should come to Michigan, or Kentucky, or Missouri, where you'll find Ford workers not just assembling vehicles, but building the future of automotive manufacturing. It's why Ford employs the most hourly auto workers in this country. Can't speak for the other guys, but we're all in on America.
Ray Magliozzi here. When you need parts, eBay Motors ensures a guaranteed fit. Hey, Dave?
Yep. Wait.
How are those new wipers?
They're small.
Just go to eBay Motors, where the check means a guaranteed fit. Let's ride.
Buy great conversations or moments that matter, but you can invest in them. At T. Rowe Price, our strategic investing approach can help you build the future you imagine. T. Rowe Price, invest with confidence.
This is a story that takes place every Saturday. There's magic rocks, wild animals, techno, and rivalries that go back decades. This story has everything. Want to hear it?
UFC 293. Buy it on ESPNplus.com/PPV.
Matt Berry back in our college football studio. Peyton Thorne's going to get a little taste of Pac-12 After Dark. That game's going to kick at 10:40, or we'll move it to ESPN News and move it back here to ESPN at the conclusion of Alabama and Texas.
Thanks, Matt. How much fun is this, folks? If you're a fan of Texas or Alabama, you're nervous about the outcome. If you just love college football, look at this scene. Look at these two programs, these two brands, burnt orange and crimson, on the same field, and they are throwing haymakers. And we've had four touchdowns in the last 4 minutes. Remind you the landscape. Chick-fil-A bringing you the AP poll rankings here. Bama came in three. And Texas just kind of on the fringe of this. The teams in the top 10 have lost or really struggled, except for Alabama, and we'll see. Texas keeps getting tested. They keep making plays and passing the test, but now back to work, just a three-point game, 11-08. Ewers and his playmakers have been giving Bama's defense a lot of trouble in the second half. Screen. Sanders again. Tight end takes off. Look at the big man move. A flag comes flying in. This will be against Texas. A scrum at the end of the play. The
left tackle, as you saw, Chris Banks grabs on to the defensive back.
Rolling
in space
on the field, the player was down.
They'll review that. It'll be a spot foul. Jatavion Sanders, his ability to just release from the line with such quickness. A big man moving fast. What a weapon he is.
Holding on the offense. Number 78. A 10-yard carry from the spot of foul.
First down. You got a big tackle and Banks trying to block Kool-Aid McKinstry, which is a tough thing to do. And he gets around him, so that's his answer. But you're right, Chris, about Sanders. I mean, you look at one of the premier tight ends in the country, 6'4", 245, a matchup problem. But that time with Sark's play action again off of first and 10. They've been doing it all night on first and 10. Another successful one, Alabama out of position. And it comes back after that hold.
Well, they're behind the sticks now, first and 15, instead of being in Alabama territory. Brewers scampers, and that's a throw in the ground. Nobody open, and Tim Keenan was pursuing him.
Kendrick Blackshire, who's in for Marshall in the middle of this defense, watch him sniff this out. They've heard all week about the potential of Sark in the screens. That time he does a nice job of feeling it, reading it, and even if it was caught, it's going to be a loss.
And this Alabama front, which doesn't have a sack tonight, begin to impose itself in the final 11 minutes. Empty backfield against the three-man rush. Ewers throws across the middle and has Jordan Whittington, and he's still going. Whittington breaking tackles and diving down into Alabama territory. Got away from Malachi Moore, of all people.
Yeah, boy, is Ewers calm, cool, and collected. We've seen Texas defense have some openings in the middle. This time, Ewers has time. Look at the eyes. Look at the poise. The composure comes off. Sees that opening. Zone defense makes a great throw.
Whittington is a big, physical dude. North of 200 pounds and tough to bring down. Ewers again looking to throw, and it's Baxter. Takes the flip, and but it's almost like a running play. Picks up about four before McKinstry gets him.
We're going to have to keep updating Ewers' first and 10 stats. I mean, this has been remarkable what Sark's been able to do. Instead of waiting till third down when everybody knows you're going to throw, he said he's going to be aggressive. He's in here to try to win this game, and he's calling this game with that in mind.
Ewers over 300 yards off the left side. Baxter plows forward. That's very near the marker inside the 40.
Yeah, and Sark's a run first, set up the pass type of guy usually, but he knows how hard it is to run the ball on first and 10 between the tackles. So breaking some tendencies, and it's really paid off for him.
Yeah, very pass heavy tonight. 24 runs, 37 passes. Use a handoff inside the back, so that's how they don't throw it on first down and pick up just a yard.
Yeah. He knew he didn't want to see a lot of that tonight, right? I can't get over this guy. He looks like he's at a Tuesday practice. I mean, look how calm he is. His feet have been calm when he's thrown, his composure. And this is what you're looking for. He got hurt in that Alabama game, came back 4 weeks later, had a couple decent games. Everybody talked about Arch Manning coming in. He just went back to work, and it's really showing tonight.
Lewis from the pocket, launching downfield. Mitchell, touchdown, Texas. Aggression and execution, 39 yards. Wow, haymakers keep coming.
Well, right on cue there, we're talking about his composure and how he handles things. Again, he's reading this safety. Downs, and he's got receivers underneath that impact the safety. So he knows again, we saw this earlier on the left side. This time they go to the right. Creates a one-on-one matchup. Was a mismatch with Mitchell against Trey.
Gotta go.
I'll always hate you and your overrated school.
I'll hate yours too.
We're still gonna out-recruit you.
We have higher academic standards.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
Introducing new buttermilk biscuits in sweet and savory flavors. So everyone can have their perfect biscuit. Or add one on the side. Get a breakfast biscuit sandwich with a side for just $7 for a limited time.
Well, they've learned horns down here in Tuscaloosa, but it's horns up by 10 all season long. Student sections across the country competing in the Taco Bell Live Más Student Section of the Year. Download the Taco Bell app to learn more. Didn't take them long to adopt what Oklahoma and everybody else who plays Texas does, but guess what? Texas is backing up their confidence, and they have the lead again. Kendrick Law has a chance to return this one, and he's going to be knocked down right at the 20-yard line. Just cannot get over the way Quinn Ewers has played tonight.
Yeah, and it's been from the beginning. We kind of set the scene. This was early, a big deep ball, put it way up in the air, allowed Worley to adjust to it. Sark deserves a lot of credit for the way he's put him in a position to create some matchups that are a big advantage. Sark said we're going to get 4 or 5. When we get him, we got to hit him. All this talk about what's wrong with Ewers in a deep ball. 0 for 7 against Rice. Wasn't great last year. He showed a lot of composure all game till that. He came over to the sideline and he was feeling that. 3 for 5 now on balls 20 yards or longer with 2 touchdowns.
So Bama looks struck back quickly, has to do it again down 10 here. Milroe launching downfield and over the head of Isaiah Bond. Why not, huh? Holly?
Well, guys, Quinn Ewers has been so calm all game long. He gets to sit down in front of his position coach, draw on the whiteboard. He occasionally goes over the offensive line, says, let's stay refocused. But after that last drive, he allowed himself some exuberance. He came over, chest bumped with Vince Young, and then he came up to the offensive line screaming, one more, let's go finish this. He is finally putting the cap off.
Love to see a great report, Holly. Milroe trying to answer, throws it into heavy traffic. Conversation with Quinn was interesting because I think that the changes he made away from football in his life, talked about embracing his faith. No one urged him to do that. He just said he kind of flipped the switch and became more religious and more calm and more commanding. And it's applied itself to his football, especially in an atmosphere like this.
Yeah, just talking to him, forget football, just talking to him. He was just seemed to be at peace just with his life. I think he has perspective now. It's a lot of pressure, obviously, on him last year, trying to live up to all the unrealistic expectations.
Milroe drifting back and now just steps right into the pass rush of young Anthony Hill. Welcome to college football. This guy's going to be a nightmare for Texas opponents.
He's trying to make a big play. Now, anytime Tommy Reese talks to him, it's about trying to just take what's there. I know it's third down. Obviously, he can't take a sack, but he did have some open receivers there underneath. But when you predetermine where to go with the ball as a young quarterback and it's not there, you don't have that second and third option sometimes to pick up.
Much as he hates to do it, Saban has to punt it away, 4th and 18, and burn it from deep in his own territory. Launches a high, deep punt that's just going to bounce sideways and out of bounds near the Texas 30. Matt, what do you have?
Gentlemen, a night of fantastic finishes around the country in college football, and right now this one's getting good. Tanner Mordecai in Wisconsin have woken up on the road, on the Palouse, once down big, now down 2-24-22. And don't forget tonight, big one in UFC. Adesanya arriving against Strickland, main card live now on ESPN Plus. Houston and Rice are tied at 28. We've got all kinds of stuff happening on a busy night in college football.
That's great.
Adesanya, the style bender. He knows how to finish opponents off. Can Texas finish off Alabama here?
You saw his last.
It's a metaphor. I did. He put someone to sleep. Baxter on the delay. Haven't had a ton of production from the ground game tonight, just enough. That's Tresman Marshall, the tied linebacker on his back. They've been hit in a vulnerable area. Look, the job isn't done. As Ewers says, they want to go get one more. Exactly 7 minutes to play here. But what you see from this Texas team, if they can finish this, it takes something truly special to come in here and win as a visiting team. We talked about the great 2019 Joe Burrow-led LSU team, one of the great teams in history, the last team to come in here and beat Alabama. Look, Texas was an underdog not given a great chance to be this impressive tonight in here.
No, but I think there are people, you have friends who are Texas Longhorns fans that are saying, man, let's put in Murphy, or what about Arch Manning? You know, that's just fans being fans. But Quinn Ewers, I think last year felt that.
Yeah.
I think he heard things like that. This year, I don't think he's listening to that. I think what you're seeing from him, this is not an aberration. This is who he is this year. I think he's grown up. I think he's matured. And I think he's letting the game come to him without trying to force the issue. And he and Sark together, and how they're going to draw plays every week, are going to be a force to deal with this year.
This is where the new clock rules, where outside of 2 minutes in each half, it doesn't stop for a first down or out of bounds. So Texas has a better chance under these rules of really chewing and milking. You can see they'll run this play clock down. But six plays, Kirk, of 30-plus, five of them for Sarkisian's offense in the second half. Five 30-plus plays against Saban's defense in a half. Brooks off the right side. And he's still trying to push the pile forward, drag down about 3 yards short of the marker. It will be third down.
Ted, we're talking so much about Ewers, but they haven't had to rely on the backs. They only have 83 yards rushing. But I think they've had to have just enough from that running game throughout this game. And the offensive line, that's a veteran group. All five of these linemen started every game a year ago. And all five come back this year. It's very rare to have that kind of continuity up front, but they have that. So they have the ability to run and the ability to throw. Bama's got to load up and sell out against this run game right now.
Crucial to get off the field here and not let Texas move the chains and chew the clock, but they do that. First down, Jonathan Brooks, drag Blackshear. Tick, tick, tick. Texas feeling good right now, and Saban's going to spend a timeout right here, already having to use one.
We've been bragging about Sanders as a receiver tonight. He's at monster night, over 100 yards. Watch 80 get out in front to the left. Actually, it's zero get out in front. Sanders just shows you that he's a total package. Big night receiving, takes on Kool-Aid McKinstry. Another tough run there. He's short by about 2 yards at contact, but goes right through Blackshear, the linebacker, to get that first down.
Would you say tonight just enough for the running game? That was just enough, and it impacts the strategy now in the home stretch. Saban having to burn his first timeout right here before a first down play.
There's something about a team that's been wounded. When Sark took over that first year, remember, they looked like they were going to be okay. Then they had like five or six straight losses, had a tough year. Last year had some big wins, but had some difficult losses at 8-5. A lot of these guys went through some of those games, some good and some bad. And they hear all that negativity. I think when you bond and you come together, you become a really dangerous veteran team. And that's what it looks like Sark has here in year three.
Brooks off the right side. Look, you come into this place, and we've been documenting it. You can't think of a more impressive win in college football these days than coming in here and winning as a visitor. And yeah, it's only game two, and Texas fans know that they stumbled and sputtered. They had that six-game skid you talked about, another timeout spent by Saban. But then they had a letdown last year and some shocking losses, and things didn't end the way they wanted. But maybe, Kirk, they've learned from that, and part of being a veteran team is just going every week back to the job and not letting the outside buzz build and get in their heads.
That's what I'm saying. When you go through that as a veteran team, you go through those losses and you come back. I remember Ed Reed. Remember Ed Reed in those early 2000 teams? Remember him being hurt in that game against Florida State? And a great shot at him. That's because he and that group and that class, they had suffered so much. And it was like he was determined to lead that team. This Texas team kind of has that kind of vibe, that they've been through enough misery.
Well, they're down to just one timeout, Alabama. So serious urgency to get the stop here as Brooks on second long bounces it. See if he'll spend it here again. Yeah, they've used all three timeouts here on these plays, trying to preserve as much of the clock as they can, down 10. Well, the CFP National Championship Trophy, which is taking up residence for times in Alabama, Georgia, of course, grabbed it the last couple years. Monday night, January 8th in Houston is the championship game. And certainly Alabama hoping to get their clutches in the Dr. Pepper trophy again. And this is one of those, and they're not out of it, by the way, even if they can't come back here. But Texas is going to seriously join the conversation and jump way up. Everybody's.
Oh, yeah. Now, Sark's been aggressive all night. He's been going for it. He's been doing what he needs to do. Does he throw the ball here as much as he's trusted yours? I think he does. I think you try to go for that knockout punch. Conventional wisdom, you run the ball, you keep the clock going, they're out of timeouts. I think he's trusting yours. I think he's going to try to throw this ball and pick up the first to end the game. Or not.
Well, they hand it off to pick up the first down and perhaps end the game. Brooks with a burst. And the Texas offensive line and skill people beginning to flex out there.
I think maybe Alabama's thinking the same thing. Look at this. You got it. Motion. DB running with him. Nobody in the middle. Because of the formation, they put six defensive backs on the field.
The parting of the Crimson Sea. Sark said, I like that call. They got 14 running on third and seven. And now this clock is really going to be able to bleed away. And Saban can't stop it. Right now, his team can't stop Texas. Elon Robinson for about three.
Texas will shoot up in the rankings, you would think.
You think?
I'm saying Alabama. It's in the end of the world. Yeah, no. The athletic directors and the coaches that are willing to take on these kind of games, I think you play it early in the year. What's Bama going to drop to? What do you think? Like flip? You know, you go down to that 10 area?
Yeah, because, you know, I mean, look, Texas, I mean, if you're going to rank seriously on what teams have done so far this season,
they should shoot up.
You can make a case for them number one. I mean, is that going to happen?
Right.
But they're going to be in the top two or three or four.
But I'm just saying Alabama, while they feel like it's the end of the world, it's not. You know, they got to fix a lot of things, but that's what you do, you know.
Well, their schedule is filled with a lot of challenges, but a lot of opportunities to stack up some quality wins. They may have no margin for error, though, Kirk, going into the SEC.
But I'll say this, before they even think about rankings and all that, there's so much that they've got to take care of. They got to figure out their identity on offense. Is Jalen Milroe their quarterback? Where are they going to go? Their defense has some potential. They made a lot of mistakes. They had some busts in coverage. They didn't tackle particularly well. So it's a lot to figure out before they worry about their season, you know, how they rank in the standings.
It'll be a long laundry list of things to fix in that man's agenda.
Looks like Sark's going to call a timeout.
But, you know, you're right about folks in Texas saying, you know, yours, he's had his chance. He can't be any better than last year. Malik Murphy, let's give him that. I had a lot of people DMing me saying that. I don't think you're saying that now, but in Alabama, the conversation might be, you know, Milroe showed some nice stuff, a couple of deep balls. We know he's a great runner. The two interceptions were crushing. Will there be an internal conversation in the Alabama coach's office to think about what to do going forward?
I think there has to be, right? I mean, there's a reason Milroe's playing, because he's performed the best. He has the best command of the offense. But after a night like this, depending on, you know, the direction of where they want to go as an offense with a new offensive coordinator, you got Tyler Buckner, you got Ty Simpson.
You got South Florida, Ole Miss, at Mississippi State. Those are the next three, so perhaps a chance to evaluate. Meanwhile, it's third and seven. Will they run it again? Yes, it's Brooks, and this time to be dragged down a couple of yards short at the 35, and that 40-second clock keeps running. It'll be now near 2 minutes when they have to snap it this time.
Texas next step, handling prosperity. Everybody, you know, Texas, it's one reaction or the other. Either what are we doing, fire everybody, or oh my God, Ewers going to win the Heisman and Texas is going, you know, so you have to be able to handle both things, right? But I think this team has the maturity to be able to deal with that.
Need three to just keep it and start kneeling down. Alabama,
there you go,
jumped there.
It's kind of fitting. That's a fitting ending right there.
Sark knows that's it. That is going to do it.
Wow.
Offside on the defense, number 17.
went into the neutral zone, causing a reaction by the offense. That's a five-yard result and a first down.
You know, Sarkisian was mentored by Pete Carroll early in his career. He goes to Washington, not supposed to be any good. They beat Pete Carroll in USC, beat his mentor, not just that year, but the year after. Another look at us. So he said that was sweet, because massive respect for Pete. I said, would this be different coming in here and defeating Saban in Alabama? Not that it's personal, but he knows how tough the job is. He says, oh, yeah, this would be the best.
He's had a confidence about him all week. I just think that he just felt like he had a team that could do this. I think he felt he had a quarterback that could come in here and do this. Give him a lot of credit. Building this culture in his third year, and again, calling these plays tonight against Nick Saban and Kevin Steele. Ewers made great throws, but they had some great matchups that were created by pre-snap movement, some different formations, personnel groupings. He lived up to his reputation tonight.
For Sarkisian, so many things go into being the CEO of a huge program like Texas. Mentioned building the culture, you have to acquire the roster, develop it, but then you get to game day. Steve Sarkisian is flat out worth points on Saturday. He might have been worth quite a few points tonight, right? But you
Amen.
Can do that and do the rest of it.
Like I said, he and Ewers are going to be a lot of fun to watch this year.
It's a loss for the SEC that is added to a list. South Carolina losing to the Tar Heels, LSU beaten by Florida State, A&M today hammered by Miami, and now Texas, future SEC team, but in their last year, the Big 12, comes into Tuscaloosa and snaps a 21-game home field win streak. Texas is 2-0. I'm not going to say anything more than that, but they look like a contender tonight. It's Sarkisian almost consoling Saban there. It was a little bit of a reversal.
Look at this reaction.
You know, for a time, Saban, ex-assistants, couldn't beat him.
Yeah.
Jimbo Fisher did get him. Of course, Kirby Smart got him. And now, the third time, a former Saban assistant has beat him. Only the third time in 31 games. Let's hear from Sarkisian with Holly.
Well, Coach Sarkisian, you wanted an aggressive mindset. How was your aggressive play calling, throwing on first down, all the ways that you were aggressive tonight? How did it pay off?
Well, I mean, I think the biggest thing was I told the players just to trust me. We were going to be aggressive in everything that we did, and I had to back up what I preached if I want them to play that way too.
You know, of all people, how hard it is to win here in this place. What does it mean to you and to your program to get a win like this on the road?
Well, I didn't want to tell the guys that they were 52-1 in their last 53 games, so I guess they're 52-2 now.
All right, you had a pretty good performance from this young man back here. Tell me, Coach said you guys had to trust him, that it was going to be an aggressive game plan. How did you trust your coach?
We always trust Coach Sark. I mean, he's got it dialed up, and we prepare the way we prepare, and we're hard to stop.
The last drive of the game, you guys were over on the sideline, refocus. How did you keep your entire offense calm, poised, and focused tonight?
We knew this whole week, if we came in here, we were gonna ball out, we were going to try to make him quit.
You've given up a lot in your life. You've sacrificed. You've shown discipline. How did it pay off for you tonight?
And it's huge. I mean, God is so good. I can't say that enough. How much God has put me through, and he's made me so much, so strong. I'm so proud. My team, you know, our defense, we balled out. I'm fired up for the rest of the way. Fired up.
You know, the whole world, the whole media, everybody's going to say something about Texas after this game. What should it be?
Nothing. We still got a lot of games to win. We're still going to roll, though.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. God bless. Let's go.
Yeah, let's go, baby.
Yeah, there's no proclamations about Texas being back. He knows there's a long way to go. He knows what's happened in recent years. But, man, just stop and savor this for a second if you're a Longhorns fan. Singing your song in Alabama's home field. First double-digit loss for Saban here. See, it's a milestone for Texas. 349-3 for that guy right there.
This is college football right here, man.
Knocked out of the game in the first quarter against these guys. had to watch Bryce Young bring Bama down the field and win late. You got to appreciate this. Alabama mistakes contributed, Kirk. You know, 10 more penalties, a couple of interceptions by Milroe. They tried to respond to Texas, but in the end, just too many mistakes, frankly, and busts on defense, too.
Yeah, I mean, I think everybody's going to take away the fact that Texas came into Tuscaloosa and Sark beats his mentor in Nick Saban. What I'm taking away, and you and I go back to long time with Texas. There's the hits with his son. That's pretty special. This is a landmark win for this program, not just Steve Sarkisian. Texas has needed a win like this for a long time. It's cool that it happened in week two. It's not the end of the season. He'll do a good job of keeping this in perspective. But this brand has been away a long time, and tonight they're back as far as showing people they can play with the best teams in the country.
I'm thinking of Bill Little, the great Texas administrator who passed away recently. Nobody loved Texas Longhorns more than him. And Bill, I'm thinking of you because he would have celebrated this as much as anybody. Texas fans all over the world, this is a big night. 34-24, Longhorns over the Crimson Tide. Hope you enjoyed tonight. It was haymakers from both sides, with Texas the last man standing. Bill Fidel produced the game. Jimmy Plant directed it.